Why cannot I turn off the radio? Depends who you're listening to. Anyway. Hey there. So that's my response to you, by the way. Call Greg the Internet Guy.
Oh, boy.
G-Tig in the house?
Get in at the response to everything.
Call Greg the Internet Guy?
I need
guy?
To pull more chicks.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Call Greg the Internet Guy.
Okay, I'll do it.
That wasn't the question. You downloaded what? What'd you do yesterday? 100 and how many? What? With
a few
what?
Days ago. 137 songs off someone's computer.
Gosh,
well,
yeah.
let me refresh. Yes, it's always good to do that on radio. Hit your refresh button. There you go. Hot Carl Scott received a video iPod amongst his gifts for Christmas from a very generous soul. And
I want to thank Vinny.
Right. And he has now, because it's a 60 gigabyte deal, he has like room for like every song in the world.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Twice.
And he's been trying to put as many songs as he can on his video iPod, and he's getting them from all weird sources. And you did what with 100 and some odd songs? You downloaded the songs, you couldn't even use them.
Yeah.
Because they weren't in the right format.
Correct.
And I'm telling you, call Greg the Internet Guy. The dude called me like a year ago saying, hey, do you want every song ever invented?
Oh, my God.
Every song ever published? I have them on catalog.
Jeez.
And I believe him.
And then he sent me a list of it, and he wasn't joking.
He's got it all listed out for you.
He's got like everything. I'm like, dude, I wouldn't need 96% of those songs.
I know. I'll take this one.
I don't like them, though.
I don't need row, row, row your boat.
Oh, come on.
He has it live, too.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh.
Let me tell you, that brings the house down.
Acoustic.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you might need it because your son might really enjoy it, you know, well, listening to it in the house.
The point is, he definitely legitimately has like every song on MP3 or whatever he's got it on. And
wow.
He's got it all cataloged and...
in alphabetical
you
order.
Can get that now, and if you really want to put all these songs on your iPod, call Greg the Internet Guy.
Does that mean he has to come over?
He'd be happy to give them to you. I don't know how he'd have to do it. He may have to come over and break bread with you. He
may have to move in.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Hey, dude, is it okay if I go number 2 in your house?
He'll probably want to do number 2 in your house, and he'll ask if your wife could jerk him off, but...
Oh, wow.
It may be worth it to get all the songs.
Yeah, aside from that, a lot of guys would do that.
I'll ask her.
A lot of guys would make that straight.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So your wife will say, sure.
Yes.
You know what that is? She's never heard of that before.
Well, I'm sure one of her fourth graders could tell her.
No doubt.
Yes, she teaches a fourth grade class?
A third now.
Oh, third.
Wow.
Well,
upgraded.
They'll definitely know. Anyhow, the answer, again, now that you're all...
is blowing in the wind?
Oh, jeez.
Which is one of the songs.
You really are out there, aren't you? Yes, that is... we have the live version of that, too. Done by Guns N' Roses. Anyhow... the answer, as now everyone is updated on to what we're talking about here, is call Greg the Internet Guy.
Okay.
All right.
He's the man.
Yes.
Have you put a lot of videos on there, too? Or
I haven't even dabbled into the video world yet.
Really?
Wow. I'm just still working on music.
You can download shows like that you love, like The Office.
Right.
Was The Office any good last night?
Awesome.
It was good last night.
I love it.
Because it was a new one, right?
Yes. They're on a booze cruise. And it got wacky. Oh, yeah.
Let me tell you something. You put booze cruise and wackiness together on a half-hour show, you're a guaranteed success.
I guess so. I watch Dancing with Stars, so, you know, whatever.
You don't watch Dancing with the Stars?
No.
Any stars
dancing,
you want.
Yeah, Dancing with Stars.
I see.
It's the stars.
The UPN version.
Yeah. Angela was watching that. And
it was
awesome.
I
walked in every so often.
Did you enjoy it?
I saw, like, the last... 2 minutes that had the montage of everyone dancing. I saw Jerry Rice trying to make it happen. I saw
the guy from ESPN who totally was just out of his element.
Mm.
And got
I'm shocked that a sports guy couldn't dance.
A sports guy from Auburn.
Right. Is he from Auburn?
Yeah.
Is he really?
Is he really?
Kenny Mayne's a local guy?
Yeah.
Wow.
And Gay Lachey was on there. Nick Lachey's brother. His name is Gay Lachey.
Oh, man.
Drew.
His name is Drew?
Yes.
Well, his name
is Lachey Jr., probably.
From what I saw, his name is Gay. Gay Lachey.
Did you see Nick in the audience clapping for him his gay brother?
I only saw the montage.
Oh.
Is he really gay, though?
No.
He should be Gay Lachey.
Why?
So Nick was there. Well, what does Nick have to do besides bang high schoolers and, and go to Dancing with the Stars now that he's no longer with Jessica?
Right.
So you think he tells people he's the ex-brother-in-law of somebody famous?
Hmm.
I mean, a little bit easier to explain than the brother of someone.
Yes. How did Drew Lachey do, Terry?
He did well. He did very well.
So do they eliminate one like they do on Survivor and all these other deals?
We call up and vote, just like on American Idol, and they eliminate...
Well, who is the big dude who could barely move?
You mean Master P?
Yeah, that's who I thought it was.
Master P.
I was going to say, it looked like it was... from the music industry that we know and love.
Well, actually, his son, Lil Romeo, was supposed to be there.
It was such a low clip that I couldn't be sure.
Yeah, it was Master P with his baseball cap on.
Mm-hmm. He was barely moving from the couple of seconds they showed in that snippet. Was he moving at all through the whole his whole routine?
Well, you know, I mean, he was decent, but
I didn't know Master P was going to be on.
Yes, he is.
Does he need the money? He's got plenty of money, right?
Well, sure. Sometimes you just want to do it for the fun of it all.
I think dancing is fun.
Although,
right.
Stephen, you think dancing is fun?
Vinnie the Pooh just kind of made a sound like Master P may need the money.
Well, but he's got a show on Nickelodeon.
He's no limit,
right? Did you not know that? Nickelodeon?
I think his son, I mean.
His son makes more money than him?
He can't stand
for that.
I think a lot of his like artists and acts right now aren't really doing anything.
Sucking him dry.
Yeah, but he himself has
I mean,
stuff
I'm
going
sure
on.
He has
See,
something.
See, when Jaden starts out earning me, I open up a lemonade stand, whatever I got to do. Whatever you got to do.
Yeah.
You can't let your son out earn you until you're at least, like, 60.
Right.
Ride the coattails, man.
Mm-hmm. As soon as Benjamin's born, get to work.
Yeah,
wait,
come on.
Dad's tired.
Get in there, do some traffic.
So, it's safe to assume that that day is not today or hasn't been up till now, right?
There's no update.
Mm-hmm. Well, there is an update, and that's the nothing has
it's
happened
an update.
Yet. It's always an update.
The update is that there is no new information.
Aha, that's an update.
Yes.
There you go.
You mistake. That's an update in itself.
Update of the day.
That's a big update.
Yeah.
It is. Man, nothing to report. That's a big update.
Okay, yeah. Well, there you go.
No more.
We are on high alert.
We
kill
are.
Breath baby watch.
Ow. Yes.
Whoop, 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 whoop. Mm-hmm. We are... inside of 7 days.
That's right.
From the due date.
Wow.
The due date being next Friday, the 13th.
Ooh.
And because we are...
Well, that was a big little...
We are now over 6 hours into this Friday. Yeah. We are inside of 7 days. You know how I do the math there,
Jerry? I do.
Well, that's pretty good math.
Yeah, well, let me tell you.
It's amazing.
Hey, I wake up early for this stuff. Yes.
The T-Man.
Dollar bill, y'all. Dollar bill.
The agony of defeat for USC fan Nick Lachey, who phoned in to ESPN Radio and put to bed rumors that he slept on USC quarterback Matt Leinart's couch during his Jessica breakup.
Was there any truth to that?
No, we laugh about that all the time because I've never even been to his apartment. Couldn't tell you what it looks like.
Sure, sounds like everything I've ever heard, Jerry. Couldn't tell you what it looks like. Couldn't tell you that he has satin sheets and a nice round ass. Oops!
That he trims.
Got a landing strip.
Oh,
he is one strapping athlete.
Satin sheets.
Strapping athlete.
Yes.
It's good
now, why is Matt friends with him? Come on.
Because.
I mean, pretty boys, you know, pretty boys stick together, don't they?
Oh, jeez. Is Matt Leinart a pretty boy, too?
I think so, yeah.
Well, he just lost his status as the top quarterback taken in the draft over this past week. I'll tell you that right now.
Oh, yeah, no doubt.
Because Vincent Young?
Yes.
Is going to be the top quarterback taken in the draft, if not the number one selection. I mean, Reggie Bush went into the USC, what was it, Fiesta Bowl? No, it was the Rose Bowl game.
Mm-hmm.
As the number one pick guaranteed.
Right. Right.
Matt Leinart went in to the Rose Bowl as the number one quarterback taken, guaranteed.
So does it look like the Houston Texans will be taking him as
When the game ended, Terry, Reggie Bush was no longer the number one pick, in my mind at least,
right.
And Matt Leinart certainly not the number one quarterback,
mm-hmm.
The number one overall selection in the 2006 NFL Draft is from the University of Texas. Vincent Young!
So he's not going to come back and finish his senior year?
No.
Come on.
His stock is hotter than Google. Are you kidding?
I know.
Doesn't want to learn, you know, the last, you know.
He has soared over the past week as Superman only has before him.
Now, does Lindale White go before Reggie Bush?
Oh, no.
No?
He had a nice game, Terry, but don't get too deep with the X's and O's with me, please. It starts to make me giggle. Anyhow.
Am I tickling you now?
Oh, jeez. I thought that was for later, but anyway.
What's comments?
No, Lindale White played a very nice game. Reggie Bush was the consensus number one pick and still may be, but he may have slipped a couple of notches, but Lindale White definitely did have his stock rise as well, Terry, as we now get in depth on this. But still, Reginald Bush will be taken ahead of Lindale White, although the Lindale White has nothing to be worried about. He's going to be fine.
Oh, okay. I was just curious, because they've talked him up a lot.
Well, Lindale White hasn't even announced that he's coming out yet. Yeah. He's a junior.
He should come back.
You think he should
go
back?
Too.
Just dominate.
Yeah.
Get all the carries.
Go back to USC and dominate.
Yeah. Yep.
First player picked.
I don't know. Something about being paid, baby.
Yeah, that's true. Tough to turn down.
Not that he may not be being paid in big suitcases at USC. I don't know what the deal is, but...
Something about running through every girl at USC, also good.
Ooh.
That's a tough one.
Those California girls, you
see,
know.
That's more a comment we should direct at that Martell Webster character.
Oh, geez.
From Seattle Prep, who could have been at the UW right now. With the season that they're having, instead he's sitting on the bench in Portland, getting in for 10 minutes a game, scoring no points. Mm-hmm. He could have been running through every babe at UW, blasted a hole through the entire female student body.
Wow.
What kind of contract did he get?
He got a decent contract, but he could have gotten that same contract next year. Spend a year at least at UW, run through the women of your choice. Mm-hmm. What are you doing?
Well, maybe he has already done that. And in the process,
how about winning a national championship instead of sitting on the bench in Portland with Nate McMillan looking at you like, will you ever make it? I don't know. I'm worried about you. Do you need that?
No.
Man, talk about horrible decisions. UW, a top basketball program in the country now, Terry.
Right.
Go there. Run through the bays. Get a national championship. What is this, rocket science? You'll still get paid?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's been proven even if you tear out your knee, your ACL, you still get paid. Look at Willis McGahee, Terry. Tell us about Willis McGahee. Go ahead.
Oh, my gosh. What a star. I don't have no idea who you're talking about.
From Miami, right?
Yes. And he blew out his knee in the final game of his college career.
Really?
And everyone thought he would never get the money that he was going to receive.
Mm-hmm.
He got all that and more.
Wow.
Oh, it's special. It's a great American story.
Mm-hmm. It's a great American story. Only Kilbreth can relate. those kind of decisions I don't understand. As far as Lindell White, I mean, he's been at USC about 3-4 years now. I don't know if he redshirted his first year, but he's probably been through anyone that needed to be run through.
There's a new crop coming in next year.
There's a new crop coming in.
Oh, man.
And there'll be a new crop coming in when he's done with his senior year, too. You can only go so far.
That's true.
You understand?
I do, yes.
Yeah, so okay. Mm-hmm. I'm glad we can get that straight. Oh, you have a question?
Can I ask one more question?
Of course you can, Terry.
In regards to NFL and football and all that.
Terry wants to do a late arriving run through of the men out there in the listening audience.
No, I'm just asking a quick question.
That's why she's gathering information.
As far as you know, who gets the first draft pick?
Yes.
Is it the Houston Texans?
Yes.
And then San Francisco, right?
It's the Houston Texans, and then it's going to be New Orleans, Terry.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yes. And the Houston Texans are going to have extra pressure in taking Vincent Young, number one, because obviously he's from the Lone Star State.
He is, and maybe he wants to stay there close to the home, close to family.
But the problem is they have a relatively young quarterback on the Houston Texan team that they'd have to pretty much let go or trade if they took Vincent Young. So it's an interesting scenario, too.
Ah, okay.
Yes. We can talk about it till 10 o'clock, but why don't we move on?
Okay. I'm just curious.
And find out. No, it's a great question.
So, because I knew that was a big thing.
You're one of the all-time great question askers.
What about
Jerome Harrison? Was he a senior this year?
What's
from Washington State?
Jerome Harrison?
Oh, yeah.
Didn't he have better numbers than Reggie Bush this year?
You mean the running back who also got selected as the
first
team All-American?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what year he is.
I don't know either.
But why you ask?
Well, I'm just wondering where you thought he would go if he was coming out.
Mm-hmm. I don't think he's in the...
But he had better numbers than Reggie Bush this year.
Well, he probably didn't play against as tough a competition. I mean, USC played against some top schools outside of conference. But anyway...
Reggie Bush returns punts and stuff, too, which helps.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm-hmm.
What are we, Mel Kiper Jr. now?
What the hell's going on? Call my 900 number, would you please?
What do you think of Evan Benjamin from the Huskies?
Oh, my God.
Oh, man. Who?
Does he play for them? I don't know.
He's just throwing out names
Steven,
now.
Steven, I'm sure you can go online and find out if Jerome Harrison is a senior. And even if he's not, because he had such a great year, he's probably going to come out.
Sure.
All right.
And I'm not sure if it's guaranteed he'll be a first-round selection by any means. We'll have to wait and see. I don't know enough about him. I don't know his size, which is very important. That's going to be a detriment to Reggie Bush, Terry.
Because he's a little
skinny.
Yeah, right?
He had trouble running. Didn't even try to run him through the line against the big Texas studly defenders there, Terry.
I know that.
That could have been a sign of things to come for the NFL for him. He could only run around the little end there.
The little end.
Mm-hmm.
But when you run around that little end.
When he runs around the little end, he's pretty quick.
He's pretty quick.
But when you have to run up the middle, you call on Lindell White.
Yes, you do, because he mows on through.
Oh, jeez. Wow. Terry sounds like his agent. What else is going on in the world, Terry?
I got some news for you about Star Jones. She is...
Talk about mowing down the line. Oh, yeah.
She has mowed down a few lines.
You want a thick linebacker. You call on Star Jones. Although, I mean, if you've looked at her lately...
She's looking good. However... Mm-hmm. Let me tell you all about her.
She mowed down the line at Old Country Buffet.
Yes, she has. She admits to medical intervention for helping kickstart her weight loss.
So are you suggesting she's got a waistband or a stomach band or one of those deals?
She got a waistband.
Yeah, she does. She refuses to reveal what procedures she underwent, but she admits, yes, I did have some surgical procedure to, quote-unquote, jumpstart my weight loss.
Yes, she refuses to reveal that because they haven't offered her a free surgical procedure yet.
Right. I mean, but what's so funny about it, too, is that here she always, especially, you know, with her whole wedding and everything to her husband, Al, you know, you're seeing her with a personal trainer, like she's really, you know, taking off all this weight, and really, that's not what it is.
And now you found out she cheated, and you're disappointed, is what you're saying.
Well, it's, yes.
Well, even if you go the surgical route, you still need to exercise.
I understand that.
It's not like she defrauded you, she still needed to exercise. But
beginning, she defrauded us.
She gave the impression, to everyone that she lost the weight on her own?
Yes, absolutely she did.
Without the skilled hand of a surgeon helping her out.
Right.
I see.
Mm-hmm. And the only reason she's coming out about it now is because she's got a new book.
Well, get on the phone, get on the blower, Terry, with Barbara Wawa, a personal friend of yours, and tell her how you feel.
I think I might.
Ironic you bring that story up first on the top of your pile this morning, when today is the day that Gayest will get on the phone line and reveal to us the course of direction for the rest of his life.
Yeah.
He is going to tell us whether he's choosing in this calendar year to have gastric bypass or waistband surgery, whatever you call that deal, or continue on the path that he's been cruising down for 36 years.
Yeah.
Big. Ease on down the road.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's been easing on down the road, Steve.
No, there's nothing easing about that.
So that is going to be a very interesting little factoid that we're able to all know about by the end of this here program this morning.
Right.
Wow. Nothing like a factoid to take from every show.
Oh. T-Man factoid.
Oh, Jace!
That's true.
Which path you will choose?
In the 8 o'clock hour.
The Rocky Road.
Because he's still doped up with Ambien. That's the only way he can get himself to sleep these days.
The mask and the Ambien.
He's the only guy that has Ambien suppositories, too. We requested those.
He wouldn't take it any other way.
Yeah.
Without a mask on his face and Ambien in his system, that man can't fall asleep, Terry. Mm-hmm. Or stay asleep.
Right.
So he's got to take enough Ambien to kill a small horse. And...
little pony.
And to put on a mask.
So he can even breathe.
So he can breathe through the night.
That's quite a catch.
Yeah.
And then at that point, he can sleep soundly through the night. Yeah. Like a little baby.
Mm-hmm.
With a mask on and Ambien in their system.
Right.
Soundly to him. I bet he makes a lot of noise while he's sleeping.
Yeah, I think.
So you're saying for a potential future partner, that is something that they're going to have to consider, and that would be a detriment as far as him actually settling down with a love interest?
You might need a separate room or maybe even a different apartment.
Well, but wait a minute. If he does go ahead and get the surgery and loses weight,
he may be able to rid himself of the mask.
Right.
But what about the Ambien?
Sure. I think he'll use the whole thing.
I don't know if the Ambien has any connection to him and his weight. He just can't fall asleep for whatever reason. Without medical assistance. What?
He doesn't stay asleep. That's the problem. Mm-hmm. He's waking himself up with his gigantic snores.
Well, I thought the mask was supposed to take away the gigantic snores because it opened up his windpipe and stuff.
Yeah, it does. I think it helps a little bit. Sleep apnea.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just make sure I'm asleep. Ambien it is.
Yeah, let me make sure.
But if he's smaller, a lot of these problems would go away,
yes.
I would think.
Yes, absolutely.
Steven's on the pro side, as you heard yesterday. Mm-hmm. He wants to make sure that he comes out the winning attorney in this lawsuit.
Look at a guy like John Candy. He died in his sleep because he just suffocated himself.
Is that right?
Yep. Mm-hmm. He was gigantic. Yep. It does happen.
By the time it was all said and done.
Was that proven through autopsy?
Yeah, he just died in his sleep.
He died of sleep?
Mm-hmm. He died of suffocation because the fat roll just jammed in his throat and cut off the air.
I don't buy that. Come on.
Somebody, a football player just died of
sleep. It happened.
Apnea.
Reggie White?
Yeah.
His was a stroke, I thought.
No, his was sleep apnea.
Mm-hmm.
I know he had a bad case of it.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yes, that's
scary, man.
Mm-hmm. Well, did he make it through the night, Gay?
This past night?
Yeah.
I'm not I don't have his video camera on yet. Maybe you could tell us.
Yeah, he's got it on.
Audrey, the chat line whore.
No, really?
Is on the line. Good morning, Audrey.
Good morning.
How are you, baby?
I'm doing really good, and you?
I'm doing well. Thanks for asking. Yeah. OBWD. How did you sleep last night, Audrey?
Oh, I really don't sleep too much.
Mm-hmm. Is she aware? Obviously, she's not aware about what's hanging in the balance this morning about gay phone operators, gastric bypass, potential surgery, because who knows what city Audrey, the chat line girl, is calling from this morning.
Right.
Audrey?
Yes.
Without any more speculation, like we had an area yet, please tell us where you're calling from today.
We don't get to guess.
I am calling from Florida now. I just left Seattle the other day. I just got home yesterday.
You were in Seattle and you didn't visit us?
I was there for 3 weeks. I didn't see my kids for almost 4 years, so yeah, I saw them.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Well, so like the locusts, every 4 years you come back and visit your kids. And that was a nice reunion. It was a sad reunion. It was all of the above. What kind of reunion was it?
Everything above. It was just everything.
It was something for everyone there.
It's a big emotional roller coaster, I'm sure.
The biggest.
And now back in Florida, how do you feel? Do you feel like you belong there, or will you be back in Seattle in no time?
I'll be coming back to Seattle every 3 months.
Every 3 months now.
Wow, that's good.
And what happens in between your visits to Seattle? What do you do in Florida? You got that rap career going.
Yeah, she's singing.
Mm-hmm.
I just really love music. That's all I have to say for now.
Well, who does it? Doesn't mean everyone follows some pipe dream of becoming some rap star.
Yeah. Music, can't deal with it.
Kevin Federline's doing awesome, too, these days.
Yeah, Kevin Federline passed you on the charts. Oh, geez.
Okay.
I have Audrey's greatest hits.
Oh, do you?
For anyone that's interested.
Oh, I'm interested.
We're still selling them. For $29.99 plus a set of Ginsu knives. And here...
How the hell are we going to prop the door open?
Yes, here is her chart-busting single.
Gangsta heat, my gangsta pride. Giving you my gangsta stride. My gangsta game, my gangsta game. I'm a 24, I'm a 24. 24 hour in the game. 24 hours she's making her grain. 24 hours she's out that door. 24 hours she's getting some more. Make that money, make it right. Make sure the side. Make sure that you
radio edit there,
kiddo. You would just play it on one of the biggest powerhouse radio stations in all the country.
Bless.
Congratulations on that. Hang on the line for a second, all right?
But we also played Kevin Federline.
Oh, yeah, okay.
We played Team Prentice. Yeah,
that's true. The T-Man. Are you ready for Wild Card Weekend, Terry?
Sure.
Wild Card.
Don't worry, it's Wild Card Weekend!
Wild Card!
There it is.
Weekend.
Yeah. Already have my wife saying to me, hey, can we go to the rug store on Saturday? I want to get some new...
Do I have a carpet already?
She wants like those throw rug deals.
Right.
I'm like, this is Wild Card Weekend.
Wild Card Weekend.
How dare
like,
you
the Seahawks aren't playing. I know, but the teams that will be facing the Seahawks are all playing.
Right.
I don't know who to root for.
Sunday. Get all the to-do list stuff out of the way so it doesn't interrupt your Seahawks.
Bless this carpet being munched, Terry. I'm not going.
Whoa!
Come on. It's Wild Card Weekend.
Wild Card Weekend! I think if it wasn't Wild Card Weekend, you'd probably find a different excuse not to go rug shopping.
You think?
It's a real world marathon weekend! I love the 80s 3D!
Viva la Bam! It says in the paper that on Craigslist, Seahawk playoff tickets for the first round, which is technically the second round. You got to consider the first round already a win. People are all nervous they're going to lose in the first round, but technically, they've already won the first round of the playoffs because they get the bye, Terry.
Okay.
I know people don't like to look at it that way, but that's the optimistic way of looking at it.
Yeah,
that way
it is.
That way you don't have to worry about them losing in the first round. The first round's gone.
So count it as a playoff.
You count it as a win.
Yes.
So if they lose their first game, is it a regress from last year?
Well, technically, no, because they made it to the second round. Even though they still didn't win a playoff game.
Right, that's what I'm wondering.
But I don't think you gotta worry.
No.
Detroit is a coming. Mm. The Super Bowl will be played with the Seahawks in it, huh? OJ's.
Oh, wow.
If you look in the paper, it says on that on Craigslist right now, Seahawks playoff tickets for the first game in Seattle are going for between $1,500 and $2,000.
Wow, hot ticket.
It's a hot ticket. It's a seller's market, if you will.
It is.
In the past, like...
Sell.
Even last year when the Seahawks played the Rams in the first round, it was a buyer's market. Outside of the stadium, you saw people just trying to give away their tickets.
Take them.
Thinking they weren't going to be able to make money, but there were so many tickets looking to be sold that it was a buyer's market, Terry. You could buy tickets for way less than face value last year. Not the case this year.
No. Mm.
I see Hotshot's mind working. I can sell for $2,000 and stay home.
Sounds good. Watch those losers go out in the first round.
Whoa!
The first round. All
right.
The second
round.
Wow,
two NXS tickets for $120.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez.
The revamped NXS.
Wow. So, yeah, that's something that's a little bit interesting and to take note of. The seller's market of these tickets are just... not being let go by the people that have them, Terry.
Right.
Actually, most people don't even have them yet because they go on sale this Monday.
Right.
The line, who knows how long it'll be. It'll obviously be raining. Will that keep people away?
No. Come on.
Do you have to go to the box office or can you buy them online?
You can buy them online, but if you are willing to camp out at the box office and you're there towards the very front of the line, you're assured of getting your tickets as opposed to online and being a crapshoot.
Yeah.
Right.
But how long do you have to wait online? I mean, is that front spot by the box office when the window opens, is that spot already taken? Or could somebody go down there right now, camp out all weekend, and have that spot?
Hmm.
Pasty?
He only does that for, you know, Star Wars and stuff like that.
Mm. Well, I just want him to go down and check and see if anyone's online yet.
Oh.
I don't even know.
He still only does that for Star Wars.
Yeah,
he's not leaving the studio.
He's not going anywhere.
I don't even know where the that line is. Because it's right outside the stadium, right?
Yeah,
I would imagine.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sure.
The best thing is when I got to go look for tickets, they weren't even in the playoffs.
It's not a Paul Allen's house, is it?
I don't think so, no.
Unless you're a hot model.
But this, oh, wow. You found out the hard way, Terry?
Yeah. Please take me home, too short.
Oh, it is. This weekend is Wild Card
Weekend.
You can't wait?
I actually enjoy watching football.
Mm-hmm.
Very much so.
Fascinating. Audrey, the chat line whore.
Oh, wow.
How will you be spending Wild Card Weekend?
Wild Card Weekend.
Well, I don't even know what Wild Card Weekend is.
So I didn't think you did. Yes, because you're all rap star world kind of girl.
I don't do rap. I sing and I speak lyrics.
You sing and you speak lyrics? You don't consider it rap?
No.
She doesn't like to consider it rap. She doesn't want to be caught up in that game.
No.
She
I seem to be doing really good on MySpace.
She sings spoken lyrics, Terry.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. It's very well put.
Yeah, I don't get it.
I see the difference now. Not really. Well, we played what we consider to be your number one hit. Is that, in fact, your number one hit, or have you...
No, it's The Game.
What?
The Game.
The Game?
That's the name of the spoken lyrics song.
The
Game.
The one that we just played?
Yes.
Well, I'm asking.
No, that's not the one you just played.
She's got that's what I'm asking her. Does she have a new one that she can share with us and debut right now on the Mighty Q93?
Didn't I already do Shake That Gangster Thing for you? That's The Game.
Well, I'm asking you, listen to the question.
Is it all the same?
You just...
Man, I'm glad you're not see. I might choke you right now. I'm asking you a question. The song that we just played, is that still your number one hit that you have?
No, it's the Game that's been the number one hit. It's even number one on MySpace. People love me to death.
Right. She has the number one hit on MySpace, Terry.
Well, that's good.
Oh, no. You're not listening. Like, if you go to my page, you got to see. I've only been up for a month, and I already have over 5,000 friends, and you will see all the music people that I know and who are about to sign me.
So it's only a matter of time.
No, I'm not playing. You can even go listen to my music because I'm very intelligent with my mouth and with my mind.
You are sharing intelligence with your mouth and your mind.
I'm very intelligent. I'm very talented, and I know I'm talented, and I know I'm going to make it.
In 1 month's time, Terry, she's accumulated 5,000 friends on MySpace, which is 10,000 less than even Schwagger.
4,000 views, baby.
Oh, okay.
Well, that's awesome.
Well,
you gotta read my comments and see who's hitting me up, and then you'll see that I'm not just this little whore that everybody views.
Whoa.
All right, easy now. What's with all
this? Just
whore
is going to attack
all of you and speak the truth about the game in my music and in my words and in my mind. It's going to be all over the place, and you just don't even know who who's talking to me right now.
What's with all the testiness?
So I mean, to everybody that's listening, yes, I am getting signed. So, ha-ha, ho, bye-bye. You know what I'm saying? The ho's gone.
All right,
new life, everything's changed.
There was a time in your life where you were Audrey the Chatline ho, whore, whatever you want to call it, but now you are all raps, all spoken lyric all the time.
All spoken lyrics for everything that everybody's put me through. All my pain and all my aggression is put down on a pen and on a piece of paper. Everything that's in my life is written down, and everything goes up online. Everything goes on a CD, and everything I do is very intelligent.
Okay.
All right.
And people won't be able to buy it fast enough, is what you're saying.
Because I'm about to get signed, and I'm about to fly back out your way to do lay down some more music with some really well-known people, which I am not going to talk about, which is a true story.
Oh, damn it. And
No one's accusing
Don't
you.
Don't mix a lot of high.
She's just eager to find out who's signing me. Oh, my God.
Mm-hmm.
And attack the whole entire industry. Watch.
Wow.
So who needs to worry? Who in the industry is going to lose their status because you're on your way?
It's not status. It's just somebody speaking the truth in the different lyrics and the different ways she puts her music.
All right, but what stars in the hip-hop world or the music world need to look in their rearview mirror and
see
you coming?
There's nobody I'm trying to knock out of place. It's just the whole fact of everybody listening to me.
Yeah, but you can't help, even though you're not trying. You can't help when some big star comes along. They tend to knock someone else out of the limelight. Who do you think
that happens all the time?
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Time.
Who do you think has to worry? Who has to look in their rearview mirror, and whether they're seeing you or not, they must recognize that you are on your way. The meteoric Audrey, the chat line girl is not to be stopped. Who needs to worry?
No, nobody's going to stop me because I'm going to be famous and then everybody.
I got that part.
Wow.
Who in the industry needs to recognize that you are on your way?
Oh, they already recognize it. And I've already been talking to them and chatting with them and everything.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So 50 Cent knows
surprise,
who you are.
Surprise.
Mm-hmm. So she'll be on 50's little label soon.
Vinny the Pooh, are you prepared to play Audrey the chat line? Are you prepared to play Audrey the chat line girls music in the club?
No.
Oh!
Wow.
Come on.
Well, you are.
Yes,
who
I
are
am.
You, Vinny?
I'm a DJ.
Well, let me tell you this, Audrey the chat line girl. Vinny the Pooh is one of the top mixers in the scene of Seattle as far as the clubs are concerned. And if he's not playing you, you aren't making it. He says he's not prepared to play your music. What is he not aware of that he should know about right now?
Please tell me.
That's fine, because you really don't know who's talking to me, so I'm not even tripping on you.
Well, you won't tell us who's talking to you.
Well, because...
I don't have to. It's some really special people, though. I'm not stupid. You'll see.
All right. Some special people... She keeps thinking we're calling her stupid.
I know.
Some special people are talking to her, and she's not going to reveal who they are. That's right.
You'll just have to sit and wait for the action.
How long will the waiting
when I'm
be?
When I'm getting my first award, I'm going to just... Thank you for kidding me there.
Okay, well, that'd be nice. And
Is that a nice deed or
that'd
what?
That'd be very nice deed, yes. I'm certainly going to hold my breath. And who...
In case of blue balls, if you hold your breath that long.
Oh, it is. Who is... How long will it take, even though you won't tell us who the special
not
people
are? Not even a month.
Weeks?
Not even a month.
Will it be a month?
Nope.
These special people are going to make...
Special people really love me.
They're going to make your career just boom into greatness in less than a month.
No, not like that. I'm just saying who's signing me. I'm with them in less than a month.
So the handwriting will be on the contract. Your signature will be at the bottom line of the contract by this time next month.
Exactly.
Cool.
Exactly.
We'll be there.
You win a prize.
I love winning a prize, Jerry.
Yeah. What's the prize?
Will there be a major cash advance sent your way due to this signing? Will there be a signing bonus for Audrey or no?
We just won't know. We'll just all have to see what we know.
Now, do you already have a tour date set?
I see special people.
Terry wants to know if you'll be going on tour anytime soon.
I'll be touring soon. You'll see.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Well, that's exciting.
You don't have to believe in me because I believe
nobody,
in you.
Oh,
other
my
people
God.
Believe in me.
We
Audrey,
support
nobody's,
you.
Yeah, nobody's
some
not
other people
in
believe
you,
in me. Some other people believe in me.
I believe in the Easter Bunny more than this. Audrey, so Vinny the Pooh will have to eat his words when he won't be able to help but play your music in the clubs. Is that basically what you're saying or what?
I don't care if he doesn't. There's a million other DJs out here in Florida who already play it. Let's see, Capone's, Voodoo Lounge, Cafe Iguanas. It plays in South Beach at Mansion. Oh, geez, you could go on the Mansion website and see my birthday and who all the stars are hanging out with me. If you guys were smart enough.
Oh. Well, we don't know how to use a computer yet.
Wow.
Anyhow.
That's why you're all computer illiterate. Not my problem.
That's right.
Seattle's not too computer literate.
Mm-hmm. We're a little behind the curve here in Seattle as far as technology.
Yeah. You know, just sit there, you put me down all the time, so it's like, you know.
How are we putting you down?
No one has ever put you down.
What's wrong with you? We're your biggest supporter.
Hey, let's have a flash. Can I do a flashback?
I just played your music on the air.
Hey, this is... No, you didn't play my actual music, the CD and the music I sent over line. So
you sent music to us? I didn't get it.
It's all right. I sent one to Pasty Dave. I sent him a whole song. I sent him the game.
Oh, Pasty Dave. Very reliable source to hand
it to. You can even go on MySpace and see my music up on there if you want to hear my music so bad.
Oh, boy.
Hop into it right now. I dare you.
All right. Well, that sounds like a dare that we have to take.
Triple dog dare.
All right.
You.
What is your website, location? Where can we find you on MySpace?
Are you ready? Music is my life. 1976.28@yahoo.com.
Okay, now don't tell me that I don't help promote your career, because this is going to be the biggest audience you ever had.
That's
and
her.
Ever will have, trust me. But,
Audrey has my flaps.
I am, and always have been, Audrey, and you know this, I don't know why you're getting all angry this morning, your biggest supporter. No one's been more friendly to you.
Yeah, and you got to read what all my fans are saying about me. It's all good stuff.
I'm excited. I can't wait to go. I'm going to go as soon as we take a break to your MySpace area and check it out. Okay, baby?
All right.
All right. You want to leave us with a little lyric or what?
No, we'll just wait.
Leave us with a little spoken word. We want to hear what's what you're working on there. Come on.
No, can't.
Like, Vinny the Pooh's dying to hear it. I think we're going to get to the point where Vinny the Pooh can't help. He will have no choice but to play your stuff in the clubs. It'll be that hot.
I know. Whoa. Come on. Make me a fan.
They already love me out here in Florida, so I think Seattle's
we heard
mad
that
at
part.
Me. Okay.
Vinny the Pooh wants to be made a fan. Can you give him a little bit so he can hear what is happening down there in hot old Florida?
I already did this one for you. I already did it.
So you only have one song? You only have one little lyric you can give us, or what?
No, because I gave you that one song the last time. I'm talking about this is I sang for you guys twice. All I right, sang Shake That Gangster Thing too, and then I sang...
Well, can't you sing it again, though?
Sing something.
Yeah, I can sing it again. You want me to sing it again? Because that's the one you're going to read on MySpace, my number one song.
You don't have... What's your number two song? Right,
give us the B-side.
It's called Tuesdays and Thursdays, about the police officer.
All right, let's hear Tuesdays and Thursdays.
Oh, good. I can't wait to hear this.
Oh, geez. Go ahead. Let's hear a couple of lines from Tuesdays and Thursdays.
I'm cool talking about that on the air. Mm-hmm. So, I'll do Shake That Gangster Thing for you again.
Oh, come on. We want to hear Tuesdays and Thursdays.
You can just go on the line and see it.
It has 925 plays already. Why can't we hear it?
Well, hit it and play. Have fun.
I want to hear it live. I have the artist on the line.
Yeah, and I want you guys to stop messing around and just go on the website and let people see what
I'm accomplished. Why are you being shy? You're never shy. Let me hear Tuesdays and Thursdays. Let her in.
Mm-hmm. And do Shake That Gangster Thing for
me.
This is like huge radio play
do,
for her.
Do Shake That Gangster Thing then if you can't do Tuesdays. And do whatever you can do. Go ahead.
You want me to do Shake That Gangster Thing for you?
Is it not really you singing or something? Is that why you don't want to do it live?
Let it fly, Audrey. Let's hear it.
Let it fly?
Yes.
Okay, because you're going to see it online anyway.
Okay, we got that part.
All right, here we go.
You played all over Florida.
Are you ready? Oh, okay, you ready? Mm-hmm. Be quiet. Okay.
Yes.
Shake that gangsta. Shake that gangsta thing. Shake that gangsta. Shake that gangsta thing, gang. Huh? And another one joins, and another one joins. Mm. Another one joins the game. Ooh, we're gonna pop a color, teach you about the game. Play your hate and play your hate game. Always wanting to chase the gray game. Mm-hmm. And another one chase, and another one chase. Another one chase the gray game.
Right.
Ooh. We're gonna get that paper, teach you about the game.
Yes.
Say, shake that gangsta, shake that gangsta thing.
I know I will.
Shake that gangsta.
Ah, there it is, ladies and gentlemen, live from Florida, the hottest artist in the Southeast. She is Audrey the Chatline Girl.
Oh, yeah. Man.
And she is spreading like wildfire.
Wildfire. What's her, pseudonym, I guess, or what's her name? I mean, what is she going by?
She hung up.
She's going by Audrey the Chatline Girl. She hung out the line when she finished her song.
Oh, wow. She's like Milli Vanilli without the talent.
She kind of sounded like a little lounge singer. There was a little lounge singer.
Sounds like Audrey Hepburn more than Audrey the Chatline. Audrey Hepburn doing rap.
Right. The T-Man.
is off and running.
It is running.
People are winning $100 instantly.
And a key.
And it's not like the paying your bills situation where you could have a winner, you may not. Every time you play the dollar bill game, every single time, someone's going to win $100 instantly and get a key.
That's right.
That they'll be able to bring down to the place where the car is being given away, and they'll have a chance to stick it in to win, baby.
That's right. Zion TC Sports Guy.
And all that is, all that's needed is for us to decide what numbers to make the significant numbers of the morning. Wow. That somebody out there will need to be able to call in right now and win $100 instantly and a key to start that car.
Yeah.
The Scion Scion. That can be yours. Because you is have right. The winning key. What's that now, Stephen?
Can be yours if the key is right.
That's right. Now.
Yes.
Obviously, what are the numbers of the morning, you ask? Well, clearly, because we have our first ever Seattle Seahawk that has won a most valuable player trophy.
Yay.
Sean Alexander's number has to be recognized, don't you think, Terry?
Yes, I do. Congratulations to him.
He scored 28 touchdowns, which is an NFL record, and something I didn't realize on top of that accomplishment is that he had more touchdowns individually than 8 NFL teams had collectively.
No way! Are you serious?
He had 28 touchdowns individually. One of those teams that are amongst those 8 that had less touchdowns than Sean Alexander is the New York Jets. I hate to have to tell you, Terry. Or I hate to have to say.
Yeah.
Because it pains me to have learned this morning the Jets as a team only had 25 touchdowns the whole season, and Sean Alexander by himself
28.
Had 28.
Whoa.
It wasn't even that close between Sean Alexander and the entire Jets organization.
Jeez.
JTS.
Yes. That is crazy.
Wow.
That is.
To read that in the paper this
eight
morning.
Eight teams? More than 8 teams?
He had more touchdowns than 8 teams as a whole.
Wow.
Had. Mm-hmm.
Those must be good teams, huh?
Not the best. The least was Cleveland had 22 touchdowns. The Cleveland Browns, Terry, had 22 really? Touchdowns as a team. Sean Alexander laughing as they lie in his wake. He had 28, of course.
Boy, oh boy.
And in honor of Sean Alexander, who him and the rest of his teammates get to sit back on the lounge chair and watch all the other playoff teams bust their asses to just get to the next round.
Right.
In honor of him winning the MVP trophy, the number 37 along with your 93 in your dollar bill will be the numbers needed to win $100 instantly.
Fast cash.
And a key that may win you a Scion Scion that you will be able to take down to the... Where is the finals?
I believe it's in Linwood.
In Linwood. Okay, why
is
not?
It?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know.
Usually is.
Bring that key on down and stick it in to win,
woo!
Baby! Someone's going to stick it in to win.
Yes, they are.
Big key party.
Looking like a big old key party.
It happens in Linwood all the time.
Steven's been asking for one for a long time.
Oh, yeah. Now you got the invite, Steven. Oh.
A lot of keys in a fishbowl. A lot of female cube listeners, Steven. It's almost a dream come true.
Yes, wow. It is.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So now we have given out the numbers, and if we could find... why don't you jump on the line, see if anyone's got the 37 and the 93 and the serial number.
See, coming back.
It happens that quick around here, Jerry. Just open the phone lines, and it seems as though 73 people on the 73 lines believe they have those numbers.
Right. Check the database. Oh, I've got it.
I know. Well, there it is.
Is he coming back next year?
So in the old days, when you used to have to spread out your dollars on the floor and check them individually, Stephen, that no longer is the case. Now you just go to a computer and check your database.
Yes.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez.
And does it ding for you, or you got to look down the database yourself?
You probably go,
Does one just flare up and go ding?
You probably search 37 and look for it, and there it pops up.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's almost too easy these days.
Yes.
All right, we'll do the nickel game next year.
It's good work if you can get it. And already on the phone line, the first caller that made it in with a 33 and a 90, a 37 and a 93 is awaiting. You're on the air. Hello. Anyone
Hello?
There? Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
The same woman as yesterday.
Yeah.
It is.
It is.
It's always the same sounding woman. Who's this?
This is Sherry.
Sherry who?
Sherry Larson.
Sherry Larson.
Uh-huh.
She won yesterday? Is that her?
Yeah.
Same woman who won yesterday? No.
No.
The woman who won yesterday wasn't Sherry Larson. Have you won a lot of things on this radio station before, Sherry Larson?
Yes, I have.
Mm-hmm.
Don't they know to say no?
Pardon?
Who, Pasty?
No, people when you ask that.
Mm.
Nope, first time.
Well, technically, she can win as many things as she can possibly get her hands on.
Well, that's the fun of this game, is like, hey, try and get as many keys as you can because you want the best chance. That's why everybody keeps the dollar
bill.
But
should there be a rule you can only win one key?
I think so, too.
Absolutely, yeah. I do.
I don't know if that rule's in place.
Not official, but it should be.
Games have been going on one day. Sherry Larson has 17 keys already.
Mm. Right, I know.
Sherry Larson, have you won yet? Did you win it all yesterday? What happened to her?
I don't
know. She got scared.
She got scared and hung up?
Yep.
She didn't have the dollar bill after all?
I don't know. Apparently not.
Oh, she got...
She said, she's going to ask what I'm wearing. I'm out.
You don't want to know.
Boy, she looked at the clock. Oh, Jesus, between 6 and 10 o'clock, I got to get off the line. I'm wearing big old bloomers. I got to get off the phone. Well, she dropped off the line.
Well.
So that
creates... Missed out on her key chance, right?
That creates an opportunity for someone else.
Someone fresh. Someone new.
Oh, no way. Got to call Jen Dalton to make sure.
She's
got to win a new phone.
Who is this?
Good morning.
Yeah, who's this?
This is Japina.
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 Let me check down. Yeah, it's Japina. You're right.
Who's?
I'm sorry. I'm having a hard time hearing you.
Well, that makes two of us. Japina, what can we do for you this morning?
Well, I wanted to participate in the $93 bill, and I
Well, that's
I got
a very
it.
Nice way of phrasing it. And you have a dollar bill that corresponds with the numbers that tributes
do.
Sean Alexander's greatness?
I do. You ready for it?
Oh, I'm ready for it, baby. And
okay,
then I get, and then I'll get
L?
This. Well, then I'll get the cereal. Oh, never mind. Japina.
Wait,
Japina. Hang on a second. Oh, Japina.
It's Japina.
Oh, Japina.
Yes?
It's Japina?
Yes. Japina.
Really?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Tie and fiber? Japina. Where are you driving? It sounds like you're driving this morning. Are you headed somewhere?
I am. I'm on my way to work, and my daughter is going to be so excited that I got through to speak to T-Mat.
Mm-hmm. And where's work? What do you do, Japina?
Oh, I'm in advertising.
Who has hired you? I want to know at what office they say, oh, we need Japina to handle this problem. Call her in.
Oh, my gosh. I'm now currently assisting the Federal Way office.
In what?
Our branch in Federal Way. So.
You work for a bank?
No. Advertising.
Oh, advertising.
Yes.
That's pretty broad little business kind of situation. What do you do in the advertising world?
Well, I am the sales assistant.
Mm-hmm.
Is it for a newspaper?
For Clear Channel?
No, I work for Warm 106.1.
Yeah, okay.
It's about time I win a good prize.
Yeah, they have for cocktail contests. I need something good. I don't want John Testini.
Oh, my gosh, you guys are giving me a hard time.
Well, what do you do in advertising? Can you be a little bit more specific so we can stop speculating?
It's Yellow Page advertisement.
You work for the Yellow Pages. Yeah. Ah, super. That's nice.
Does that help you guys?
And you're on the horn every day trying to sell another bit of space.
Actually, I take care of mostly the admin office administration part.
She's the assistant. Mm-hmm. She doesn't really sell.
And it's you and it's your daughter. And who else is in the picture in your family? Is that pretty much what we got right now? You and your daughter? Is there a man to be found anywhere in the equation or what?
Of course, I have a wonderful man.
You have a wonderful man?
Yes.
Does he have a wonderful woman?
Pardon?
Never mind. And you're married to this man?
Oh, yes.
And how long have you been married?
Oh, gosh. We've been together for over 20 years.
Wow. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Yesterday's winner was 22 years
married. The hardest part of the entire marriage was hearing, do you take Japita? Your lawful wedded wife.
Oh, my God, I can't believe this.
Japita sounds awesome.
You have made my morning.
It's like something I'd order at Taco Bell.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like, yeah,
Southwestern
Japita sandwich.
Japita with cheese.
Japita, you have that dollar. I don't want to cause any accidents here, but can you read the serial number to us, baby?
Yes, I can.
Oh, she's ready to go, Terry. L.
93.
93. Get that out of the way quick.
91.
91. Get that out of the way quick.
7.
7.
37.
Oh, I was getting 9.
Emma's a Mary.
Amazon Mary, as opposed to Amazon Nancy. Terry, it sounds like a winning dollar to me.
It does sound like it.
It sounds like Japita, without even selling a bit of Yellow Page space, has won herself $100.
Woo!
And she's won a key.
Yes.
And after 20 some odd years of being with a man that she's married to, she's going to get a chance to step on up and stick it in to win, baby.
Congratulations, Chapita.
You guys are totally awesome. Thank you so much.
Oh, geez. And what's your favorite radio station, Chapita?
Seattle's number one hit music station is Cube 93.
Yeah, mine too. Okay, hang on. Yeah, Chapita.
How come when you ask what the favorite station is, they just can't
give you the
say...
phrase to pace.
They're programmed. Right.
Listeners are programmed. They have been brainwashed by the red-headed stepchild that is Eric Flowers Day.
So what's the phrase of pace? Q93?
I don't know what the answer to that
is.
They're
all confused.
Yes.
Oh, man.
But they're winners nonetheless.
They are.
In the dollar bill game.
The T-Man.
He's usually Britney's silent partner, but not this morning.
Oh!
Kevin Federline opened up to Ryan Seacrest on his L.A. radio show.
You believe Ryan Seacrest has a radio show in L.A., man?
I know. God,
what the hell? I'm sure that's hard-hitting, huh?
Oh yeah, real
that
hard-hitting.
That freaking haircut has got a radio show in L.A.?
He does.
Man.
He just signed another contract, too, to do the red carpet stuff for E! Online or something like that.
Well, that's more his style, but to do that just makes me angry.
Shocking.
Man.
He does He does the Dick Clark thing. He's uninspired too. He doesn't do a very good job.
I'm gonna have to look at his ratings. They can't be high.
What?
They can't be unless it's just all like 50-year-old women or something like that.
They do love him.
They love him down there.
The 50-year-old women do probably.
Oh, all right.
Seacrest on his LA radio show.
Were you kicked out of the house?
No way.
Online entertainment website TMZ spotted K-Fed leaving Seacrest studio where he put to rest all rumors of a breakup.
Kevin Federline. In-depth interview with Ryan Seacrest.
Oh, wow.
Out of my misery.
Yeah, that must
Are things
great.
Good with the two of you?
Oh, wonderful.
What about
Always.
The divorce reports?
He's very articulate, Terry.
Yeah, I can tell. Mm-hmm. That's really...
It says it all.
Yeah, it does.
Why waste words when you can...
Oh, God.
That's
any guy that would make that noise is a complete jackass.
The divorce reports.
Wow. Jeez. Who needs an education when you can just do that?
He's got nothing on you, huh? All right.
He needs to practice.
That's true.
Show him how it's done. And can he do Lupinella? I don't think so.
No. Oh, come on.
What about the divorce reports?
Ow! Wow. What else is going on in the world there, Terrence? We are inside of about a half hour from the big gay announcement.
Oh, big gay announcement.
Oh, yeah.
Today could be the... Oh, geez. Easy, Stephen. I know you get worked up over this stuff, but will gayest Terry decide to get gastric bypass surgery sometime in the calendar year 2006, or will his life continue as it has been for the past 36 years of his existence?
Can't wait for this big decision.
It could be just completely world-altering kind of stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, let's say he, like, gets gastric bypass surgery, gets thin, and then all of a sudden, who knows? Let's say he just starts liking women.
Wow!
Maybe he was gay just because he was so fat.
I had no other choice.
And then we have this new gayest who's not gayest any longer. I mean,
wow.
I mean, you can't rule it out as a possibility. I mean,
anything's possible.
It may be a little far-fetched.
Yes.
But you can't say no for sure. All of a sudden, you can walk into the studio one day and say, hey, see the tiggies on that girl out there.
Because there's no straight bear club, that's why.
I like to suck on those.
Whoa.
You never know.
If you're gay because you're fat, then I'm Liberace.
Maybe. You are pretty handy on the piano. Maybe it's just that, you know, he could never get girls all his life, and he was always ahead of the curve with weight. Even in fifth grade, he was heavier than the average fifth grader. And,
yeah.
And because of that, he had no choice but to be gay.
Ooh.
I don't think it's as far-fetched as you think.
Oh.
It might happen.
I'm making a good case for it?
You are.
Okay. I'm glad you're buying into it. Anyhow.
He was in Future Fags of America, so.
Oh, yes.
I don't know if it's too true, because he did join that club.
That's true. That's a good point.
Don't really know which way he's going to go. It's tough.
I think it's pretty clear.
I don't know. I thought it was clear, but then, you know, the Shibata thing. I mean, that made me put me over the edge.
Does have a way with food words. He did certainly hit home,
yes,
I'm sure.
He
certainly hit some buttons in Gay's inner being when he brought up all those food references yesterday when he made the argument as to why he should not even consider getting any kind of surgical procedure.
Mm-hmm.
Leave it to a 300-pounder to talk a 400-pounder into keeping the course.
Not tough to do.
Stay in the course. What else is going on in the world, Terry? We will find out that information in just a matter of moments.
Well, a couple in Florida thought their elaborate prenup agreement would keep their marriage intact, but that's right. It didn't work, unfortunately. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And it was a prenup that included back rubs and...
Back rubs?
Yeah.
So what does that mean, back rubs? Any time one would ask for a back rub, the other would have to comply?
Yes, that is correct.
Oh, that's grounds for divorce right there.
Well, but if you both agree, and like I said, in the prenup, that's how it was all written out. If I request one, then fine,
then
and vice
versa.
Then,
of course, someone starts abusing it. That's six back rubs in 3 days!
Well,
are you kidding me? Get the hell out of the house!
There was also
that was in their prenup.
Yeah,
they put little stupid stipulations like that in there.
Yeah, very, very.
Whenever one wants a back rub, the other has to comply.
Yeah.
Does it say how long the back rub has to be?
No. Well, I mean, it doesn't give me all of the.
It's not really a back rub unless you've got at least 5 minutes, Terry.
Well, I'm sure there was a time limit set in it, but it just
probably not. All right, what else?
They also said a $5 fee was in there for nagging. So if any time one of them nagged the other, then there was a $5 fee.
I'll give you $5 just to shut your hole! Was that in there anywhere?
No. But unfortunately, it
but
didn't
But that's
work.
All shades of gray. What qualifies as nagging? What crosses the line? What straddles the line? What doesn't approach the line when it comes to nagging? One person's nagging is another person's talking.
Right. That's true. But
just the sound of your voice.
What wife out there really thinks she's nagging, even though she has... way past the boundaries of nagging.
Well,
you can't believe it.
Yeah.
Well, I'm just talking to you, and if you can't handle it, you're married to the wrong woman.
Wow.
Yeah, you don't hear it. Where's my husband? I'm going to go nag him.
Mm-hmm.
So what to you,
oh, he's definitely watching
to
the
you
game.
As husbands constitutes nagging? I mean, what is a nagging wife's... I mean, what kind of things does she say that constitutes nagging to you?
Right.
If she says, hey, honey, do you mind taking out the garbage? Is that
give
nagging?
Give her $5. Yeah, I'd just rather pay her off.
I'm sorry, what's that now, Terry? You sound like you were nagging.
Dead, Terry.
You know?
Take out the garbage?
Or, hey, honey, do you mind not leaving your dirty drawers on the floor and pick up after yourself?
Mm-hmm.
Put them in the dirty clothes hamper?
Right.
Saying dirty drawers once, I think, is not nagging, but if you consistently do it, then that would be...
Well, if the husband keeps leaving his dirty drawers on the floor,
oh,
then...
Oh, Lord. Steven seems to have all the answers when it comes to nagging.
I'm trying to figure it out.
No, about dirty drawers, he knows.
Right. That, too.
So...
Especially when he, you know...
Steven, dirty, you just today. Dirtied your drawers yeah. again there? Are you right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right in the hamper.
So when one of the two married partners would nag the other, they would have to pay a $5 penalty.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, they say that is why husbands live longer than single men is because they have a wife that nags them.
Is that right?
Yes.
So nagging, at the end of the day, is a healthy thing for men to be on the receiving end
yes.
of. Whatever.
Yes. They say a married man lives longer than a single man because of...
I never heard that. Because his wife will nag him for years and years?
Well, because they have a wife who is, you know, concerned about their health and things like that.
And
well,
it's the nagging...
It's the nagging of like, hey, you need to get to the doctor. That kind of
stuff. It keeps him
stuff.
In line.
Yes.
It keeps him safe and protected.
Right. I mean, when you're single, who do you have to, you know, remind you about?
So we should be paying you $5 for every time you nag us.
Pretty much.
Because you're saving our lives.
That's wow. right.
Either that or making us want to hang ourselves. One of the two. I see, I see. So even though they had this very craftily written prenuptial agreement with all these special stipulations, they're getting divorced.
They are. Mm-hmm.
Made it all of what, 2 years?
not even that long.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. We thought they had all the answers.
Yeah.
Dummies.
Mm-hmm. They're so crafty.
Yeah, they thought they were cute doing that, I bet, in their prenup.
Yes. So they ran out of $5 bills. And it was I see. All right, whatever.
Oh, aren't we a special couple? No, I want to kill you.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
But do you take a check?
Yeah.
All right, so they didn't make it. What else is going on? What else? You got to get some stuff out of the way here, Jay. What else do you have?
I got a story here about a 59-year-old Oklahoma pastor who was very much against gays. I mean, he preached it. It was his whole lifelong, you know, thing about preaching against gay and the gay lifestyle.
Yes.
Well, he got busted for soliciting a male prostitute.
Oh,
nice.
We have, audio of the... actual scene right before they were busted, Terry, and it sounded something like this.
Yeah.
So that's a little bit hypocritical is what you're trying to point out there?
I would say so.
He was just doing research for a new sermon.
Oh, his main conquest was to rid the world of homosexuals, and he himself, through it all, was undercover.
That's right.
Undercover angel.
Yeah.
Midnight fantasy.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, whatever.
He even claims, you know, that it was all a setup.
He denies every inch.
Yeah, every inch of it he is denying.
Yes.
He claims he wasn't picking up the undercover cop because that's...
He was giving her a ride because Eddie Murphy doesn't do that anymore.
Yeah.
Or him a ride.
Yeah, he was actually pastoring him.
I see.
That's what he's claiming.
Mm-hmm.
He thought it was a 14-year-old girl. He didn't know.
Where did this happen?
I thought it was a 7-year-old boy. It happened in Oklahoma. He is the reverend for the South Tulsa Baptist Church in Oklahoma.
Not anymore.
And actually, I think I can try and get you a mugshot of him.
Wow, nothing like a pastor's mugshot. That's lovely.
Yeah.
There it is. So. That's the new millennium. The lineup of pastor mugshots just continues to grow.
Mm-hmm.
Terrific.
Yeah. So
with the turmoil of hiding in the closet makes you lash out against the gaze.
Pasty just handed it to me. Is this it? Ah.
I hate that guy.
What does Lou Piniella think of this guy?
I get tired of making excuses for that. Hall early. Hall late.
Oh, yeah.
All right, glory hall early.
Pick a hall and stick with it, would you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Unbelievable.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay. Get Gay on the line if he's out of his ambient coma. And when we get back, Terry.
Coma.
Are you ready for this?
Well,
when we get back, his decision on what direction he will be taking for the rest of his life.
Wow.
And what if he says, oh, I'm going to need some more time? Like, he needs another day. Does he get another day? Or
he doesn't get another day.
Tables, offers off the table?
There are no more days.
Okay.
Wow. We find out now, or his inability to answer the question is answer enough for us. That would be an answer equivalent of a no.
Okay.
All right?
All right.
Wow. Okay.
Big day.
Make this your screensaver, too.
Oh,
right.
Yeah. He's
the T-Man. He's a gay phone operator. He's so gay. He's so phone operator. And now, here's Gay. A good morning.
Good morning. Yes, guest. He has not much to say, Terry.
I know.
It's a big day for the gayest phone operator in the world. For the gayest man in the world. 419 pounds at last check, Terry.
Really?
Boy.
And today is the day he decides whether to throw himself on the operating slab.
Get on up there.
And get his his stomach rewired, if you will.
Well, there you go.
Or eliminate it to some degree.
It's more like
Will he, this time next year, be the size of Vinny the Pooh?
Whoa!
With all that excess skin. Terry, he'll have so much excess skin, it'll look like he has a goose-down comforter on his chest.
Oh, man.
I mean, that's something he has to consider here. But the overall decision that he has to make is whether today marks the day that could alter the rest of his life, Terry. Or will it be more of the same? It'll all be known in a yes or no response that will come up in a matter of seconds. But first, let's reflect back on the existence of Gayest a Phone Operator as it pertains to this show. Ah, the memories, Terry. And all the memories that have been made through the years. It started with faxes.
Oh, yeah.
Then a phone call or two.
Yeah.
And then all out terror.
Yeah, you know that it all comes down to participation. It all comes down to contributions. And you have given us none of that.
But Rubber Boy, you know what? You bitch and moan about getting royalty. Why don't you show the royalty back to the people to do everything they can for you?
Like the corners of my mind. Misty watercolor memories of the way we were.
Well, you're ripping a guy who's helped you out in the past, making fun of him for taking a bus to work, but he's conscientious.
I didn't make fun of him for taking a bus to work.
Maybe he's trying to save some money as opposed to stealing it off PayPal. And then buying ice cream machines and trying to hire someone to serve you.
Whatever. So, hey, Jimmy, you want me to take the side down?
Yeah, take
you
a
know what, Craig? Don't do it. Uh-oh. Don't do it, because I will get those goddamn pictures. I will print them myself, and I will give everybody a goddamn copy.
Can it be?
No, it never was.
Oh, has time rewritten every line?
Kids like back then!
If we had the chance to do it all again, tell me, would we?
Kids like back then!
Could we?
Good morning. Hi, it's the gay phone operator. It's the Cube 93 birthday party game. If your birthday is August 16th, you just need to be the 93rd caller.
Not really.
Call now at 206-421-9393.
Not even the number anymore. We simply choose to
forget. How is it that they're putting on a reality TV show? Two teams, both with a quest to lose weight, and you're not on this show. How is that possible?
I don't know. I would do it.
You would have been awesome on that show.
I know. Perfect. I didn't even hear that.
You would have broken down and cried.
I did not know about it.
He wants to be on.
Perfect.
I would have done it. I seriously would.
It would have been a ratings bonanza.
Yeah. How about the loser part two? I'm sure you'll still be qualified.
You should look into seeing if they have a second one already lined up. Man. And then apply.
It would be fun. I'm telling you.
Just a couple of moments, Terry. Mm-hmm. Just the most we could find in the past 5 minutes.
Oh, wow. There's so much more, though, right?
We're sick of playing the Lord guy.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
Is that the deflating gay?
But back to the...
That's the first decision. Oh, man.
Back to the current moment. Oh. Back to the question at hand.
Wow.
Back to the live.
Won't be as fun to dip him in chocolate if he says yes, though.
And in color action. He'll be the size of Annie the Pooh, I'm telling you.
Oh, yeah?
Man.
That'd be amazing.
I mean, you saw Mona?
Yeah, Mona looked awesome, by the way.
Gayest phone operator.
To bring down more cookies.
You sit there in your home with a cotton candy machine to your right. And with a cake that says Happy Anniversary Bob on your left.
Half gone.
Because it's half eaten, it used to say. Elaine, too.
Babala.
Mm-hmm. Gay, you heard yesterday morning, I imagine a lot of listeners did as well, the arguments put forth by the legal team of... you had Hotshot putting forth his closing argument as to why you should not even consider what you just threw out of nowhere a couple of days ago on the program that has us to this point. And then you had Kilbreath, who was taking what you said the other day and is running with it, telling you, you must do this. This is the time in your life you must seize. And a moment you can't let pass by. You've had more than 48 hours to sit, reflect, analyze what future events are possible in your life. You've had all time for everything as far as looking back and forward. Now the time is here to make your decision on what you intend to do as it pertains to gastric bypass surgery. And without further ado...
Wow, we're doing it right now?
We are away... What do you want? What do you want, a Rose Bowl parade?
Jeez!
It's raining enough, Steven, for it.
Jeez.
Gay?
Yeah.
Why do you sound so somber? This could be the happiest day of your life.
It should be.
Either way, I mean, you have had the free will, you have had the ability to make your own decision.
I understand. Whoa.
Then why do you sound so somber?
Because I've just been worrying about a lot of things and thinking about a lot of stuff.
Okay, share 16 or 17 of those things with us. Go ahead.
It's just a lot of going into why I should do it, why I shouldn't. I mean...
All right, well, don't make it like it's life or death. Oh, wait, it is. All right,
okay.
Man, you sound ultra serious.
Well,
Yeah. It's a big moment. It's a big moment, but come on.
But either decision he makes, it's you know.
It's the right one or the wrong one or...
What's the right for him?
Is there a right and wrong decision clearly here, Terry?
Well, I think there is, yeah, absolutely.
Do you believe that as well, Steven?
I do believe that as well, yes.
Hot Carl Scott?
Of course.
Do you all agree on what the right decision is and what the wrong decision is?
Probably not.
No, not even close.
Now, I know you made the case yesterday for the anti-surgery decision, there, hot shot. Do you truly believe that that's the way he should be going here?
Of course, I do. You feel better by yourself if you do it on your own.
Even though I told you that was the way you had to argue, you truly...
Luckily, I believe that, yes.
Luckily. And, Stephen, do you obviously believe that...
Without question.
I didn't even need to ask.
Unequivocally.
Oh, jeez.
Whoa!
Don't even try it next time. Anyhow.
I got a word of the day calendar.
Gayest? Gayest?
Yeah.
Can we get a little cheer out of you?
No.
It's a happy day. What?
No.
Why not?
Can we do a cheer for you? Give me a G.
Oh, jeez.
Give me an A.
Why are you weeping?
Just because.
Why Micah Gay gently weeps?
See the floor. It why are you sweeping?
Why are you weeping?
I'm just upset, okay?
Over what?
Over this whole thing.
How many people get an offer to have their gastric bypass surgery funded for them, Terry?
He brought it up, too.
He brought it up!
Yeah, we're not pushing this on him.
Am I complaining? No, I'm not complaining, so just stop.
It's still a life-altering decision,
maybe
either
way. Maybe he's got the best advice. Maybe we should just stop and forget this ever happened. No decision, that's it. Goodbye.
Oh,
wow.
Yes, this is stop, Terry. I don't want to pay for it.
Easy out.
Well, not if he's going to be like that.
Tell us to stop.
That's true. He doesn't really see... Does he seem emotionally, you know, capable of handling something like this?
Either way, don't you guys understand that even if he says no, he realizes that he will live even just as short a life. I mean, even shorter. I mean, and that's because he's going to end up getting bigger and bigger to the point where we're going to have to call in, you know, some big machine to get him out of the house.
Oh,
the problem is he can't emotionally handle it. I agree with that, but he can't emotionally handle what he is now.
Oh, right.
So at least this will give him a chance.
Just, yeah.
Put on the hot pink spandex and the fanny pack and get to the gym. Everybody else in America.
The hot work.
Not everybody else in America does it. We just read that Star Jones had a procedure done to jumpstart her weight.
All right, if he puts on the hot pink spandex and goes to the gym, I'll pay for the surgery. How about that?
Okay.
How's that for the deal? I thought he'd call right back, like angry that I hung up on him. He's not even calling back.
Well, no.
Wow.
It's emotional.
Pay for his gym membership. That'll be a lot cheaper.
But he won't go.
Buy him a juicer.
Are you going to go with him?
I've actually offered to go with him.
Are you serious?
I've offered to go with him. I go. I'm 290 and I battle
what
it.
What is that?
It's Gay's phone.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you have the mental capacity to probably deal with it, and he doesn't.
What's his old number?
He's calling.
Oh, he's calling us. Are you back? Are you better? Are you feeling all right? What's the deal?
I'm just upset about the whole thing.
All right. Well, then don't worry about it. We'll forget it ever happened.
No, I'm not saying that.
We'll forget you ever brought it up.
Wow.
How about that? I don't want to put you through all this trauma.
No, because it's the same thing. It's like Scott thinks I should do it on my own. The problem is I can't do it on my own.
Well, then we're giving you an option.
I understand that.
So who cares what Scott thinks?
It's all about you,
Gay. I don't want my friends and family and people to think that I'm copping out.
But you're not, Gay, because there are so many people who have done this.
Wait, hold on, Terry. You're stepping on...
That's not funny.
You're stepping on Meltdown of the Year right now. Yeah. Okay, go ahead. What's that?
This is not funny, you guys.
No one's saying it's funny. Who's laughing? I just don't want to put you through this. You sound like a wreck. That's all I'm saying. Who's sitting here laughing at you? You're amongst friends! Huh? Yeah.
I can't do it myself.
Sounds like you made your decision then.
And so your decision is
to do the surgery.
Oh jeez, we didn't get that. Oh, he got cut off, Terry. Get the whole
ass. Dump, dump, dump.
Oh, we have to dump that. He said a dirty word.
Yeah.
So what does that mean? That means I offered this like 6 years ago. He didn't want to do it. I offered him a $15,000
right.
bet.
Right.
He didn't make it.
Right.
Because he couldn't do that.
Mm-hmm.
His decision is to do the Sergey twins.
That's what he really said.
Not
he cut it off.
Funny.
But the fact that he's broken up because Scott will be mad at him if he does the surgery.
Stupid.
That
is
very stupid.
That his friends and family will. What do you care what they think?
He thinks you'll be mad at him if you do if he does the surgery.
He thinks I'll look at it as him
copping out,
taking a shortcut.
Yes.
Never. I'm sure that's what he's really worried about. It's his biggest worry.
Yeah, I guess.
Uh-huh.
That's what he said.
All right, there it is. We'll do the surgery. There it was.
Woo-hoo!
Big buildup. Glad you enjoyed that, ladies and gentlemen.
Doesn't seem ready to do it.
Mm. Well, no.
Balling like an idiot.
Is he?
I don't think he's ready.
Get him back on the line if he's balling like an idiot.
I'll be there and hold his hand at the surgery if he would
so
like.
So will I.
Wow. Both hands already taken.
Yes. You guys get the feet.
I'll hold a foot. Yeah. The big foot. Yes. Anyway. Is he back on the line? Sounds like his decision has been made, ladies and gentlemen. For those of you who had yes in the office pool, you can collect the funds now.
Big winner.
From your coworkers.
Yeah.
Seemed pretty clear to me which way he was going to go. He's going to get the surgery.
Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, Gay Phone Operator has announced to you all, I'm sure you're all just amazed by this big radio magic moment. He is going to get gastric bypass surgery or some sort of weight loss surgery in the year 2006.
Yes.
Although he has to pass a mental evaluation to make sure that he's mentally fit. Not to mention physically fit for this type of stressful procedure.
They have to go through that, don't they?
As he sucks up the moisture live on the air. But that, just to be clear, that is obviously what decision you have shown us you've made here, right?
Yes.
Okay. Would you like to make a statement at this time?
No.
Well, you have to.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
For giving me this opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's it.
No, there has to be more.
That's it.
10 minutes, right?
So this doesn't excite you at all?
It does excite me, but I still feel bad because I can't do it myself.
So what?
God.
It's not about so what.
Oh, dear. What is it about them?
I've had so many people make fun of me and call me fat and lazy.
All right, well, those days sound like they're going to be over now that you've made this decision.
I appreciate the offer, and I'm accepting the offer. You just don't understand, and you never will.
But see,
we don't have to understand anymore. You're going to be skinny. Right? What does it matter if people don't understand? Understand what? That whole past 36 years was just a dream. This is the new Gay Phone Operator. We'll put you next to Vinny the Pooh. We'll dye your hair dark and we won't know the difference.
Wow.
But you know, for 36 years, your life's revolved around food, so you're prepared to change your life. You cannot do what you used to do.
Right. He understands
that.
I don't think he does.
I don't understand. I realize how big a change it is.
How are you going to feel when you drive by a Jack in the Crack drive-through and you have no interest in getting online?
The interest will still be there, but I can't do it.
Well, they have Diet Coke there.
No, you can't drink pop after doing this.
Really?
Oh, well, I don't know research. That.
Steven will never get it.
No, he never will. And actually, that's
understand.
A healthy
I've
water and stuff.
So much, and I've checked into it, and I know what you have to do and what the difficulties are and what the risks are.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Sounds good.
All right, so you ready to give up pop and all kinds of other items that you have embraced and enjoyed through the years?
I have to.
Huh? Wow.
You know you can do that.
You have to so you can be sure to be there when your kids graduate high school.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm worried about.
Oh. All right, well.
Yeah, we don't graduate high school in my family.
There it is. Ladies and gentlemen. What an uplifting moment it has turned out to be.
I thought it would be, but it's kind of not for some reason.
Of course it's not. Listen to the guy.
But he got to choose, so you'd think he'd be happy for him.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not for some reason.
No, because I'm a big letdown to everybody. Just
Here we go.
He's already failed the
Who
test.
Who cares
Don't
about
go.
Us?
You got no shot.
I care about you guys. I care about what people's opinions of are of me.
Why?
Move him down on the dysfunctional family list for that.
Mm.
How about off?
How can you have to pay me off the goddamn list?
Okay. Congratulations on your decision, Gay. It's a very happy moment here on the program and for the entire dysfunctional family.
Now it's time to begin the process. Now it's time to begin the process of seeking out potential surgeons, Terry.
Sure.
Of getting him mentally and physically prepared for this procedure.
Right.
For setting a date for the surgery.
Mm-hmm.
For swabbing him up with alcohol.
Oh, boy.
For what else has to be done? For
The anesthesiologist to knock him out
mm-hmm.
and suck him out.
Yes. All this, these steps will be put into place now. Maybe the first call we make is to Dr. Tony Magabat,
mm-hmm.
our cosmetic surgeon to the stars, who could point us in the right direction.
Yeah.
I don't think this is his specialty by any means.
No,
I don't
but
think
I'm
he,
sure he's got people in the
I don't think he does this in his office, but he certainly knows through networking in the medical trade who
right.
to point us in the direction of.
Sure.
He's probably got an opinion on the surgery.
And all this begins today, Gay, because you've made the decision that had to be made.
Mm-hmm. Well, you think he's a train wreck now? Wait till they tell him he failed a mental test and he can't get it.
I don't even think they put you through a mental test, do they?
I'm sure they
probably should.
Yeah, yeah.
Dr. Tony had to kind of put you through a test.
Get Dr. Tony on the line, please.
He does. He's
some guy just emailed and said he sold the stock in Boracini.
Wow. You wish you could get all the money back for the food you ate?
I mean, that's funny, Gay. Can't you at least laugh at that one? It's a funny line from a listener. Listeners have a lot of funny lines, and you got to be able to laugh every once in a while, right?
Yeah.
The sold the stock at Boracini is a good line. Quality listener line. Can you laugh about it or no?
No.
You can't laugh at all these days, can you?
But maybe you will in 6 months.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, look at Al Roker. He looks great.
There's your motivation.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez.
See, Halloween, I'll be able to go as a flying squirrel as my costume.
Oh, jeez. Someone tells me he went last year anyway.
Wow.
Anyhow.
Think how long you'll be able to stand in the catcher's position.
Mm-hmm.
Think how long you'll be able to stand regardless.
Yeah,
that's very big for yourself.
I know. It's a good decision.
Okay. Any final words?
You can actually run in the Emerald Downs race.
Any final thoughts?
Thank you again.
Mm-hmm. We go to the buffet. I'll only have two plates, so
you're
I won't eat in front of you.
You're going
to
look like a combination of Danny Bonaducci and John Curley in a matter of no time. All right?
John Curley, is he still alive?
He's still alive.
So well done on your decision.
Thank you.
All right?
Way to go.
Any We're final thoughts? You want to take some calls from the listeners?
Maybe he can host Evening Fagazine.
Oh, dear.
Try to start his own show.
Might not be a bad idea.
Mm-hmm.
We're very supportive, since you care so much.
Thank you.
But he won't think this is support, though. That's
no, problem. He doesn't, but we are supportive.
You want to take some calls?
I don't care.
Well, if you don't care, then why should we?
Because well,
I think
should.
We should.
Yeah, of course we should.
Got to care.
He does.
He doesn't care about anything.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter anymore.
You want us to call and tell Wally the good news?
No.
Okay.
Shouldn't Pappy Papperson be wired in on this decision?
No, he should be dead if I had a choice. Oh. Okay? It doesn't really matter what he thinks.
He was pulling for you yesterday.
No, he wasn't.
Mm-hmm.
How about Chris?
Yeah, right. Don't even start with that.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, oops.
Already did.
I think his mustache just got even more twirled up based on this happy news.
He already knows about it.
Oh, so you told him before us.
Yeah, I did.
You know what? That's not right. He should be disqualified from
wow.
surgery.
No, you know what? I needed to talk to somebody that I
And
know.
How was he? How was he?
He was supposed to break the news to us first. We were supposed to get an exclusive here, Terry. And Chris from the cuff.
Got the breaking news.
Got the breaking news before us.
It's in the fine print of your contract.
It's in the fine print of the contract. I'm out of the loop.
It.
I don't need to be involved anymore.
Show me the contract.
Oh, jeez. All right, hang on the line. When we get back. Should we line up calls of support, Terry, or just calls that are going to blast them?
Well, you're going to get both.
Mm-hmm.
Let me imagine what the text pagers have to say, too.
Oh, yeah, the text pages rolling at 97373. That's 97373. Don't you know?
The T-Man.
Terry, we advertised that we were going to have Gay Phone Operator in a little call segment where he would field calls from the listening audience based on their reaction to his landmark announcement that he's going to get the gastric bypass surgery, Terry.
Yes.
However, he's too much of an emotional wreck right now to be on the phone line.
Really?
Wow.
He hung up the line. He's, I don't know what to call it in a clinical sense.
Mm-hmm.
But just in layman's terms, he is an outright emotional wreck over this decision. What it should have been... when it should have been a happy days are here again moment.
Wow.
He is crying like a blubbering I don't.
Gay phone operator.
Yeah. The phone operator.
But can you really? I mean, he's the only one that we've ever really talked to you know, make this decision. Maybe the others who have had the surgery was just as tough as a decision.
I don't think so.
Okay.
Anyway, it was a nice try, though. What else is going on in the world? Until he gets back in the line and he's convinced that everyone sees him as an ultimate failure now, and that's the angle he's going with, crying like a hysterical baby, feeling like he's let everyone down, I guess, which is just a weird point of view.
Right, it is.
I mean, who cares?
Right.
I let everyone down every day. Do I care?
Right. What else? He's not letting people down.
Right? What else is going on in the world, please?
According to a recent survey of women ages 18 to 70 years,
right.
Mm-hmm. 62% say what they really want this Valentine's Day is a traditional handwritten love letter.
And it's Valentine's Day coming up again?
Oh, yeah.
Candy's in the store.
Gotta start thinking about Valentine's Day already?
That's right. Right around the corner.
Man, I was thinking Valentine's Day. That's way up. Then I actually took a second. It's only a month away.
Yeah, it is. Yep.
Lord.
They cherish that more, by the way, than jewelry, like a diamond.
I didn't even hear what you said after Valentine's Day. What did you say?
Oh, I said that women want an actual handwritten love letter.
Over what?
Over, like, candy and jewelry and your flowers and things like that.
So you're telling me that you put in one bin... a diamond necklace, which would fall under the category of jewelry, right?
Correct.
And in the other bin, because I'm big on bins, Terry.
Yeah, what's your deal with bins?
I don't know. I don't know where to put it. In the other bin, you put a nice handwritten sealed note.
Love letter.
That they're aware of is handwritten from the person they love.
Yes.
But as soon as you grab it one, the other is ripped away. And you know that going in. Mm-hmm. And as soon as you grab at one bin, the other bin is taken away for life. You're never getting it back.
Right. Mm.
You're going to tell me with a straight face that the women, the majority of them, are going to reach for that handwritten sealed note bin over the diamond necklace bin? What, you think we're stupid? You're going to insult our intelligence? Don't do it! And everyone just thinks I'm a failure.
Okay. Wow. Oh, they're going to grab the necklace and say, hey, dude, can you tell me what you wrote in that note for me?
Of course.
Express your love to me, not in written words.
Women would bum rush that diamond bin like a DVD player sale at Walmart.
Wow.
Are you crazy? Are you crazy?
I'm just telling you what the little news wire says.
Well, the news wire is fraudulent. It lies. It's out of whack. It doesn't know the realities. What is that, some survey done by women? Oh, I'd love the handwritten note. Bull crap! You know what you want! You're a woman!
You're a woman.
Oh, that's good.
No, that is...
Right, yeah.
Exactly how it sounds. You're a woman, and women don't know what they want. They think they do. They're convinced that they do. But there comes a point where they even realize, I have no clue as to what I really want. What a shame. Anyhow, so I believe that they meant it when they said it, Terry.
Mm-hmm.
However, it's not truthful.
Ah.
It's not the reality, and it would never happen that way. When I put it in terms like that you can understand, you know, the one with the bins?
Yes, the bins. I recall the bins.
You can't even...
Bin with a diamond necklace.
You can't even help not arguing with me based on the scenario I painted for you.
Well, this...
The bin scenario is the only way to come up with a truthful idea of how women would react.
Okay, here's my argument for not running to them with the diamond necklace.
There's no argument that works! My argument is the final word.
Oh, okay.
And that's all that needs to be said.
The burning bush has spoken.
I'll hear your argument. Go ahead.
Okay. For let me waste your time a little bit more than I do every day.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, jeez. I've gotten very nice pieces of jewelry from my loving husband.
Oh, jeez.
Wow. So I don't need any more jewelry.
Oh,
I've gone to the romantic dinners, and that's mm-hmm. very nice.
Mm-hmm.
And I've gotten flowers in the candies, and I don't need candy because I'll get fat.
Oh, jeez.
So therefore,
get fat.
Yeah, I'm fatter than I already am.
As she sits there with her slathered banana bread.
Oh, I saw her make
the run
for it.
That was awesome.
No, you are very much for your age and shape. Yes.
Right. Anyway, so actually,
yes.
A nice love letter, heartfelt, would be a great Valentine's
but
Day.
But how many of those love letters would actually pass the love letter litmus test? Let's say you open that envelope. How many men are capable of really writing a letter that satisfies the woman in their life? How often would a woman open up the envelope, read the letter, and be like, oh, beyond my wildest expectations of what I thought that dummy could put on paper.
Well,
hopefully she'd appreciate the effort.
Yeah, that's the thing. I think that
it's not about effort. It's about getting it done or not getting it done.
Well, but I think that any woman who like has them and thinks that, okay, yeah, I can't believe he actually wrote it down is not open-minded enough.
No woman who has a shot at a diamond necklace is going to open the envelope and say, well, it sucked, but he made an effort, so I'm really glad I didn't take the jewelry.
But he shouldn't
be with her.
Right, but I really do. I think that women appreciate at least the effort and the heartfelt love coming from it, because
luckily for my wife, Terry, I'm a never-ending walking love letter.
Oh, really?
So
you're always spewing love to her?
So that any love letter on paper would just be more of the same of what she gets every moment of every day.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
Well, she's a lucky gal.
Right.
So.
Sure.
So she's taking the necklace.
Got it!
She's
no dummy. She'd dodge right through the neck. Who wouldn't? I would.
I mean, but how many diamond necklaces can you buy her?
Give me two bins. Give me a diamond necklace to put around my neck.
Yeah.
Along with the other 20 that I have.
Oh, you have 20 diamond necklaces?
No, but I'm saying...
We should all be so lucky.
No, I'm saying your wife. I mean...
Oh, my wife.
Yes.
You went through a jewelry drawer?
No, I'm just saying, for example.
Mm-hmm.
A drawer? Full of jewelry?
Oh, yes.
Man, that's pretty big. Holy crap.
It's just a
room, actually.
It's just a waste.
Vault,
it's just a waste of space type article. It's a ruining of a perfectly good tree that could have been sitting in the forest all happy when they put that on paper wherever you got it from.
What the hell are you supposed to write in a love letter? There once was a man from Nantucket.
Mm-hmm.
Like a little poem or something?
I love you. Well, if you have to put that on paper to let her know, well, then there's something wrong with the marriage or the relationship.
Not necessarily.
No. Mm-hmm. Why can't you just express?
You tell us a romantic one. What would you put in a Valentine's Day love letter? Go ahead.
I don't really know. I've never written one.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe
roses are red, violets are blue.
Sit down and write one this year.
What rhymes are blue? How about poo?
Well, I'll tell you what you've done.
Roses are red, violets are blue. I know you wish I was Vinny the Pooh.
I'll tell you what you've done. You've given a lot of men a light bulb in their minds right now that says, hey, I could save a lot of money this Valentine's Day by sitting down with a piece of paper and a pen. Yeah. And in turn, you're going to have a lot of disappointed women come February 15th. All I got was a lame attempt at a love letter. Thanks a lot, Terry Free.
Well, those are ungrateful women.
Give me that back. Next time, keep your mouth shut is what they're going to be telling you on February 15th.
No, I don't think so.
Okay. Well, you're just a messenger, Terry.
That is right.
But
I am.
But you seem to endorse the articles you
read. I do. Okay. I think that's sweet. I think it's
all right, whatever.
Nice.
What else is going on, Terrence?
I mean, geez, you can buy jewelry any old time. What do you need Valentine's Day for, huh? Right? And granted, you could write a letter any old time. But, of course, they pinpoint Valentine's Day to be that special day.
Mm-hmm.
When every day really should be that special
day. Oh, geez.
Oh, wow.
What else? What else?
I have another study.
It's a can't-win holiday as far as I see it.
That's brutal, man.
Yes. Brutal's a good way to put it.
I have another study for you. This time, the study was done by the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee.
Is this going to be another waste of a tree?
Sure, in your mind, I'm sure.
Go ahead.
They found that cell phones are actually breaking up your family. They say that people who are, who bring home their cell phones and leave them on at home, have less quality time with their family because they're always answering the phone.
Right.
And so they're less satisfied with their family life.
Well, why would that be any different than having a landline in your home? It's just as apt to ring and just as apt to take away from your family time. Why is this something new? People are, they're bringing their cell phones into their house to try to save a little money on what it would cost to have a landline.
First of all, I think,
cell phones ring more than regular phones?
Well, I think cell phones are not only used personally, but for business as well. Mm-hmm. So when you keep your cell phone on, you also have business calls as well as personal calls. Whereas with your landline, you don't give it to, all your clients. At home.
No client should be calling you past 5 o'clock. Business is done at 5.
Leave me alone.
Or in our case, at 10.
Yeah, but they do, as Stephen calls himself.
10:30, I get so pissed.
I got a lot of clients calling me at 10:15. I'm really annoyed.
Yeah. Well, luckily, we don't have real jobs and have to deal with that.
Right.
I don't even know what a client is. Anyway.
I mean, people who own companies and, VPs of businesses and so on.
So what you're saying
sales.
Is cell phones are ruining the fabric of this what once was a nicely woven country.
Yes.
It's destroying the very fibers that are the family and our world.
Yep.
Okay, I'm willing to live with it.
I got this from the Journal of Marriage and Family.
Mm.
So there you go.
Well, that makes it all authentic, Terry. They sound like they know what they're talking about. They should know something about marriage and family.
Sure.
If they're the Journal of Marriage and Family.
Yes.
The home phone can be just as annoying.
Yeah. So on the cell phone, your message says, call my landline.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Family's ruined now.
Hey, listen, honey, get out of the room. I'm talking to a solicitor.
Okay. Est.
Yes, sir.
Have you gotten yourself together?
I'm okay.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Okay.
Crystal the cuff.
Hide it.
Whoa.
Okay, well, it's a happy day. You realize that now, maybe, that you've taken a step back and got a little perspective on this, or what?
I've made a positive decision, I know that.
Mm-hmm.
Good job.
Okay, but you're letting everyone down, but that's okay.
Oh, wow.
Or some people.
Don't let them get to you.
Yeah.
It's an easy way out.
You can do it, gang.
No, you're making the right decision.
You can do it.
There's no way about it. No two ways about it. And that's why I'm sitting here willing to sponsor this whole thing, Terry, because I feel like I'm saving a life.
There you go. And you are.
Do you want us there to hold your hand during the surgery? Did you like that offer?
He'll be.
I'd like people to come and visit me, yeah.
Do they put you all the way under? I guess they do.
Yeah, they do.
Didn't we establish that yesterday?
Yes, sorry.
I thought it was a stupid question when I asked it.
Okay.
I mean, the chainsaw noise is a bit much for some people.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to take some calls?
Well, sure. C-section, they don't put you all the way out, so.
Yes, they do.
Mm.
They do?
They did for me.
Hmm.
Yes. I don't think they do.
Here's the man who wanted to speak with you yesterday. He's dying to speak with you again today. You're on the air. Hello. Turn your radio down or whatever is going on in the background, sir.
Wow.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah. Sounds like some gay jargon.
I know.
There.
Gay jargon.
Hey, yes, sir. What's up?
What's up, Steven?
Something being wide open.
Oh,
yes.
Yeah,
arriba.
Go ahead. You're on the air with Gayest. You're on the air with Gayest, sir.
What's up, Gayest?
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm okay.
I'm in Seattle, I'll support you. And,
you're breaking out your cell phone that's ruining your family, sir. It's breaking up. And, we don't,
is it really?
Yeah, we're not getting a lot of this. I heard something about all Seattle supports your decision. What, are you the spokesman for all of Seattle now, sir?
Of course.
Mm-hmm.
At least the Seattle homos.
All of Seattle's homo community supports you, Gayest.
Yes, Gay. We do. Lose some pounds, maybe you get some.
Wow.
Exactly, they support me because then I won't be fat in your little freaking community.
Oh, jeez. Isn't it your community, too, Gayest?
I don't feel part of it.
Mm-hmm.
And he doesn't.
What do you mean you don't
feel community?
Part of it? You're most of it.
Oh,
yeah. There you go. Now you're conforming to the gay lifestyle that you don't like.
Wow.
All the pretentious gay people, you're conforming to them now.
Hotshot's still trying to.
But you'll be able to walk, so you take the good and the bad, I guess.
You were a unique gay man at one time in your life. I'm almost fasting forward now to the point where he's no longer the man that he is at this moment. But you are conforming to be like more authentic gay men.
Yeah, he wants to be a gay asshole like all of us.
Mm.
Wow.
No, you're the biggest dude.
I'm the biggest what?
Asshole.
We don't want to have that competition here.
I take pleasure in that.
I'm sure you do.
But at least I get some.
Yeah, I don't remember this one at the family picnic.
Yeah,
I'm not conforming to this freaking gay community. I'm trying to have a life.
And there's nothing wrong with that, Gay.
Well, you have.
God, I applaud you.
You have a life.
No,
now.
I don't have a pathetic existence.
And what do you think is going to be the new world for you when this is all, like, in the past?
Well, being able to go places, do things without having to worry about, is there parking? Do I have to walk far? I mean, am I able to actually get there? Can I go to a movie theater and sit in a seat and not feel like I'm going to be in pain the whole time I'm there because I can't sit back in the seat because my ass is so huge?
Because you want to be comfortable in the seat.
Well, also being able to bend over when you're having sex is fun, too.
Okay.
Oh, nothing to do with it.
Okay.
Well, you'll be able to only buy one airline ticket as well.
Okay.
There'll be a lot of benefits.
Tons. All right, there you go. Sir, thanks for checking in.
Thank you, T-Man.
All right, bud.
Pick up a hobby, man. You gotta do something.
Yeah, what's your new hobby is gonna be when you're thin?
I have no idea. It's so radically different than what I am now.
Well,
have no idea.
Is there anything you've always like enjoyed from afar but haven't been able to participate in? Like maybe like a model airplane convention or I don't know. What is something you've admired being done out there that you weren't able to do?
I would love to go see things, but I can't.
You want to travel?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This isn't all of a sudden going to make you a wealthy man, you know.
I didn't say that. But when I have the opportunity to go places, I don't now because I can't.
So for the other 360 days of the year, what are you going to do?
Where do you want to travel to?
Maybe get out and walk around and see things?
Mm-hmm.
Take a walk around Green Lake, maybe.
Ain't happening.
Yeah, it would happen.
All right, and it will, because
in the past, I've done those things. I just can't do them now.
Hmm.
Pick up an instrument, like the skin flute.
Just... Yeah, I've got that one mastered.
You should know, huh, Sean?
That's right.
Okay. Well, Gast, your decision has been made.
Yeah, come on, I'll show you how I mastered it.
Okay, let me take some, just, a lot of people have been waiting a long time. I was just about to end this, but let me take some real quick calls in rapid-fire fashion. You're on the air with Gast. Go ahead.
Bonus calls.
With Gast, go.
Hello?
Yes, real quick.
Hi. How are you today?
Not ready for small talk. Just go.
Just
well,
see what you
gotta
say.
My name is Tina, and I know you've been talking about the gastric bypass.
Three, two, one. Thanks for the call, Tina. Wow. You're on the air with Gayus. Go ahead.
Yay, keep your head up, man. Everything's going to be all right.
You're on the air with Gayus. Go ahead.
Hello?
Yes.
Hey, Gay, I had the surgery, and I know what you're going through. Nobody knew but my husband and my doctor for like 2 years. And I know what you're going through about the shame and that you think you're taking the easy way.
Okay, this will go. You're on the air with
Gayus. Her doctor didn't know she had the surgery for 2 years.
Go ahead. No,
they're the only ones who did know.
Oh, I see.
Terry picked up on it. You're on the air.
Terry speaks dumb woman.
I do not speak dumb woman well.
Go ahead.
Because I'm an idiot.
Hey.
Sometimes.
What's up? Go. You got 10 seconds. Go. 10 seconds. Go.
Hey.
Hey.
This is Tiny's wife, Deb.
Oh.
I had the surgery in, I spent New Year's in the hospital, 2002, and I lost 189 pounds, and it's not an easy decision. It's not the easy way out. It's a very hard way out, but it works, and it does give you a new life.
I don't know if Gabe wants a hard way out. He thought it was going to be easy.
Yeah, it gives you a prescription to OxyContin, I think, too. So, I just remembered that.
So now,
I'm part of the pro.
Yeah, go for it.
Why is it a hard? Doesn't the pound just kind of melt away? Do you have to work? Because if he has to work at it, he's not going to
be
successful.
It's not about exercise and that. I mean, eventually, yes, I'll have to do that.
Because I'll tell you what, gay, fat, or thin is going to be a lazy man, okay? He's not going to be able to change that.
Right.
You know, why do you have to say that?
Because that's the way it is. I've known you for years.
No, that's not the way it is.
I've known you for years, and I know what's in your head. It has nothing to do with what's in your stomach or your thighs or wherever else you have it. You do not like to work.
Fine.
But you've made the right decision nonetheless. All right?
I mean, at some point you could walk, and you were able to work out, and you chose not to. So we know that you don't like to.
Right, well, anyway, for all the calls that have been waiting and still are, and we haven't gotten to, we apologize, but that's it. More than enough.
Okay.
The decision has been made. As I said many times now, it's the right one, and now we move forward from this point. Researching? Going through the yellow pages? Whatever has to be done.
Yeah, this guy looks good.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and these guys are open for lunch, too.
Yeah, I like his ad better than his ad. Let's go with his guy. All right? You excited, Gayest?
I made a good decision.
Okay, there it is. That's a nice final word.
He's reading it off his mirror, it sounds like.
Mm-hmm.
No, I erased that a long time ago.
Well, now you can put it back on there. I love myself.
Mm.
Yeah, freaking crazy man.
Bring him in the man who could have saved me $15,000. All right, anyway. Actually, no, it would have been $15,000 either way because he was on his way there. So, anyway. All right, very good. Sounds
Thank
wonderful.
You.
Terrific. Have a great fantasy or a wild card football weekend.
Wild card football weekend.
Mm-hmm. But if all of a sudden he starts liking sports when he's thin and, women and
jeez, amazing.
Fast cars. Beer.
Oh,
whoa.
Yeah. You can't drink beer anymore.
See him at the racetrack and
gets dark hair.
Mm-hmm.
Looks normal.
See him at the strip clubs in Vegas. Cigars in his mouth.
You should get the ginger kid surgery first.
Mm.
Whoa.
The T-Man.
you, my baby. Nobody ever made me feel this way.
Yeah, whatever, shut up. Anyhow, these Pussycat Dolls are really starting to remind me of the Spice Girls, and that is not a good or a compliment of any kind, Terry.
No, because I
Because this second song of theirs, mm-hmm. this second supposed hit, is reminding me a lot of the Spice Girls' second hit. You remember that song?
Mm-hmm.
Was it like Two Become One
yes.
or something like that?
Yes.
It's got that little flow to it mm-hmm. that is very similar right. to the Spice Girls' second go at it mm-hmm. with their single.
And where are they now?
And where are they now?
One of them gets to bend it like Beckham.
Mm-hmm. Every night. Oh, my gosh.
Man.
Yeah?
And the rest are working at Home Depot.
Right.
So that is not a good sign.
I know.
Terry, tons of text pages have rolled in.
Oh.
I see you holding
Rolling.
Throughout the morning. I got too many pages here to keep track of. I'll start from the beginning of the most recent ones that we just printed out during the break and see which ones need to be read as text pages roll in all morning long. And that's 7-3, 7-3, don't you know? That's 9-7-3, 7-3. I don't you know. Let's see here. 8:46 and no seconds. I think you should.
That's pretty good.
Oh, dude. That's a nice round number for you.
I mean, to hit right there.
Wow. I think you should do the bypass surgery for Gay, but don't pay to get his extra skin removed because it'll force him to work out while he's losing weight or he'll look even weirder.
Yeah.
Make him work for something in his life. 8:45 and 27 seconds. It's the almond roca. I'm telling you, I shouldn't have had that.
That almond roca down there?
Oh, oh, boy.
Oh, baby.
Relax. 8:45 and 27 seconds. Somebody writes, hey, T, all this gay talk is making my ass hurt. How about playing some Michael for me? Michael.
Michael.
Oh, is that what Michael is? Michael!
Yeah. Wow. Okay, then.
I thought maybe it was a new music situation.
There's a new song called Michael.
Well, there was Lisa today. It's yeah, 20 was, years later. You need a Michael.
Yeah.
Michael and the Toe Jam.
Mm-hmm. I see. I understand, sir. All this gay talk has your Uranus feeling a bit of pain. So this one, sir, this one is for you. Let me tell you something, Terry, before I play this whole thing in its entirety.
Okay.
For some reason, this audio clip is better than like 80% of all porn. It's better than a lot of stuff for some reason. This
really?
Audio clip just does it.
Just that little
it's real.
Snippet. It's,
Terry, there are things in this world that just do it, and there's a ton of stuff that misses the mark.
Okay.
This one just does it.
Hits the bullseye.
I don't know who this girl is. I don't know where she is now. But I know where she was on this day, and I know what was going on.
Probably a PTA member.
Yeah.
And it just works.
Gonna be Michael.
That was a
just makes your ass feel a little better, doesn't it?
Wow, I guess. Mm-hmm. Sure. Yeah.
Can't say the same for her, but sounds like she liked it.
Oh, yeah. Sounds like she more than liked it.
And don't discount the evil, wicked laugh at the end of it, Terry. The evil, wicked laugh at the end of it is just the cherry on top that is needed for it to be better than like 80% of all porn.
Okay.
And it'll be crazy. It's still 20% of porn. It's better than that. But there's a lot of pornos you watch. You don't get nearly the rush that you get from Michael Motorcycle.
Right. Just listening to that.
Huh? Mm-hmm. Thank you, sir. Thank you for that text page. Stephen, by the way, did you work on, as I asked, as I requested of you, with the promotion staff here to get us a prize for the text pager of the day?
I did not.
Yeah. Oh, let down.
That is a letdown. I just remembered right now, actually, that you brought it up.
Oh, my God.
I mean, after the show, Anna was not in her office, because I checked after the show, after we talked about it again, but then I didn't go back.
Mm-hmm.
Because I didn't write it down, but it's written down now. I can call her right now, or I can go visit her right now.
Hmm.
Wow.
boy.
8:44 in 1 second. Somebody writes, Terry.
I was the producer.
Oh, it is.
Wow.
Whoa.
Shot it pasty.
Jeez.
Terry's wizard sleeve crushed the miners.
Oh, come on now, people.
I thought they were in her wizard sleeve.
It's a very sad story.
That is a sad story.
There are some miners in Terry's wizard sleeve right now.
That's what I
Are they lost and trying to be rescued in there, too?
No, they're not. They're enjoying it.
They love it.
Wholeheartedly.
Mm-hmm.
They love all the gas.
8:42 in 11 seconds. What'd you say?
All the gas that's in there.
Oh, that's nice.
How do you have gas in there?
Nice thought, Terry. Oh, Lord.
Gosh.
At least Gayest will be able to see his dick without positioning a mirror just right in the future.
Good. Good.
That's a nice thought, yes.
Mm-hmm. Great thought.
8:38, 59 seconds. Somebody writes, I'm going to rail my wife right now.
Oh.
Oh.
Good for you.
Here's
to the
moment.
Here's to the end of your drought, sir.
Mm-hmm.
8:36 and 24 seconds. Somebody writes, stop crying, you pussy. T-Man has given you a chance at a longer life. Be grateful.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Tough to argue.
8:34 and 16 seconds. If a man is not cheating, he's a drug addict, a drunk, or substituting women. Wives for influence. Women should shut their damn mouths and...
What?
And be flipping 100% grateful, damn it. I don't know. Some of these texts
It was probably because...
Just don't make a...
Valentine's Day reference there. Mm. About the note and all that.
Yes.
Remember?
Right. 8:33 and 50 seconds. T-Man, you're damn right. I'm saving my money this year now that Terry read that story and I'm writing a cheesy love letter to my wife that thinks I really like her.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, boy.
Yeah, boy.
That's how he ends it, yes. You're showing her, sir. 8:33 and 39 seconds. Is it weird that I'm holding my goldfish right now and giving it a little stroke? 8:33 and 32 seconds. Valentine's Day is February 14th, you schmuck. Yeah, I said people will be... Women will be angry February 15th, making a reference to the day after.
Right. Oh. Oh, boy.
But thanks for...
Pointing that out.
...being there for me and... Reminding me, I was so confused. Mm-hmm. 8:31 and 44 seconds. Somebody writes, I would take that letter Terry spoke of over jewelry any day.
Aww.
Hmm. Signed, Gayest. Call that person back.
Oh, is that our winner that gets no prize?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's more
because,
kind of winner, huh?
Because, yeah, it's great.
Hey, 30 and 30 seconds. Somebody writes, here's my letter for Valentine's Day of 2006. Roses are red, pickles are green. I love your legs and what's in between.
Nice.
That's great.
Hello?
Wasn't
here. Yes, T-Man here. We got your text page. So you were taking every word Terry said to
Hello?
Heart. Oh, just... Can you hear me?
Hello?
Yes.
Who is this?
It's T-Man. We got your text page.
Did you?
Yes.
Did you?
And I'm very interested to hear that there's someone out there that's coming right to the forefront and saying that there's no doubt about it, a love letter supersedes any bit of jewelry of any kind, of any dollar value that you could be getting this Valentine's Day.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly right.
You got a boyfriend?
Yes.
And what's the status of this relationship? You've been going out for how long?
5 months.
5 months.
Mm-hmm.
And before him, how long had it been since you had another serious love interest?
6 months.
Mm.
And we were together for 6.5 years.
Is that right?
Wow.
Yes.
And your boyfriend is, what's his name?
His name is Tim.
His name is Tim?
Mm-hmm.
So Tim, who may or may not be listening, will probably get word either way that he needs not spend a dollar on you. All he's got to do is sit down with a legal pad and an envelope and a pen.
And, that is absolutely correct.
And write his thoughts on paper.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So that means it's so, I mean, anybody can go buy some jewelry, but it has to come from the heart to be able to write a love letter.
Yes.
Take some thought.
It does.
I don't believe it, Terry. I don't buy it.
And I know I'm not the only one out there.
I'm sure you're not the only one who believes that, right?
Oh, hey.
But come February 15th,
uh-huh.
And all you got
Oh, you mean the day after?
And all you got...
15th, you jackass. It's the 14th.
All you got is a mediocre written letter to look at with some spelling mistakes. And
that
all,
would be fine.
And you're going to be a bit disappointed, whether you know it now or not. But it's a nice thought. It's a nice thing that you're at least saying. I hope that perhaps it could be true.
I could buy my own diamond necklace.
Mm-hmm.
I can't write my own love letter.
Right.
Sure you can. You haven't applied yourself.
I really love me.
Yeah. I do it every day.
I love the way I do this
to me. I write hate mail to myself every day.
Steven, you're really a dickhead.
Oh, jeez. You know the way to your heart, Steven. All right. Well, thank you. Thank you for being out there. You seem
you're like a
lovely lady. A fraudulent lovely lady, but a lovely lady nonetheless.
And
thanks
you would have been a winner, but we have no prize for you.
Your prize is no prize. Thanks, but you should be used to that.
Lazy employees around here, man.
Is that what Steven is?
Oh, you can't count on anybody.
Wow.
I get tired of making excuses.
A druist. A guy who calls himself Druist.
Druist?
Writes, that fat jalopy just needs some crack tea, man. Save yourself a lot of money. And
go fucking him all.
I'll tell you where to buy it.
Probably work.
Mm.
Then we have to spend money on rehab and stuff.
Yeah.
So, either way, you're out cash.
Angie, or no, somebody writes, hey, sexy T-Man, and I say that because we've seen your pictures in our office. Say happy birthday to our coworker Angie, not your wife. I'm glad they put that in parentheses. I was really convinced it was my wife's birthday. And that Valentine's Day was February 15th. Yeah, okay, happy birthday, Angie. Very nice. Let's see. Mm-hmm. 816, this is the one that needs to be read. He was... Well, they call him the F word in relation to his sexual orientation, Terry.
Right.
The F word stands for faggot, for those who aren't aware.
So it's not really the F word.
Right. The F word.
Oh, thanks for clearing it up.
He's a moron. He was doing it the right way with this supposed psycho trainer and rather just sucking it up until he was skinny. This continues on the next page. Where's the next page?
Yeah, make sure you get the right next page.
Yeah, I got too many pages.
If he would have just continued, Terry would have mud flaps.
Gay has mud flaps. Gay has a dickhead.
Oh, here it is. And rather just sucking it up until he was skinny and telling the Nazis to kiss his ass, he's resorting to surgery. He's always going to be an effing lazy...
F
word. Which means faggot for those who aren't aware.
Well, it could have been a lot of things.
Well,
Flamer fudge packers, tons.
Oh, geez.
It never ends.
Yeah, there are a lot of F words as it pertains to the gay community.
Yeah, that's true. It's
good. One more flattering than the next.
Yeah.
But people think it's just copping out, but I don't think it really is necessarily with him.
Of course not. See, why not take the, when there's a hard way and an easy way, and you can take either way, why not the easy way? It makes sense, doesn't it?
Yep.
Sure.
Maybe it's not as rewarding. Maybe it's not as cheap. It's not his money.
But obviously we're learning this isn't the easy way for him.
This is the hardest way on me.
Well, that's probably what he likes about it the most.
Hard on you.
Yeah.
Is that where he graduated from?
Mm-hmm. T-Man, if you came over right now, you'd see my dog in the process of humping my cat as we speak. We're not speaking, sir. Thanks for the text page. I'm keeping my stock in Frito-Lay in case he F's up and gets fat again.
Jeez.
That's nice.
What was Audrey's MySpace address again? I think she's the best voice since Karen Carpenter. All right, there's a little taste, Terry.
Wow.
Has a pretty big taste.
That's
of some of the text pages that have been rolling in this morning.
Wow.
I don't you know.
I do know.
Feel full.
Do you?
No.
What prize do we have for the person who can call up now and best duplicate this sound bite?
Oh. Wow. It'd have to be a good one.
And it has to be a man that wins.
That was a
Stephen Kilmer's right now will pave the way and show you how it's done. Go ahead, Stephen. 1-866-663-T-MAN. The person who can call up right now and best duplicate the Screamer Michael lady will win the same prize that goes to our text pager of the day.
Wedding Woo! Crasher DVD.
Wedding Crasher DVD, what?
Crasher DVD. How about that?
Wedding Crasher DVD?
Yeah.
DVD. We have the DVD of the Wedding Crasher, right?
Mm-hmm. Good movie.
Hey.
Yes.
I can't confirm that, but...
Show out
I know
stuff,
we have
Stephen.
Them, so... Cause I took
show
one.
Out stuff. Scaring me.
Is that the Wicked Witch?
He's scaring
like
me, Terry.
It's a horror movie.
He's scaring me. He's a very scary guy, Stephen Kilbreath. Was that your attempt at imitating the Michael Screamer?
Yeah.
Hmm.
There's a reason he lives in the woods by himself.
Well, let's hear all of you do it then.
Clearer and clearer every day.
You're out of the air.
Yeah, we won't.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, I can do it.
Steve, we can do better than that. I'm not saying we can be dead on. We can do a lot better than that. And so could you, by the way, if you actually tried.
Okay, well, first...
I'm not talking to you, sir.
He thinks you are. That's what I love.
Come on, Steven. Show us you could do at least a better job than that. Try. Apply yourself.
Well, let me hear the whole thing again.
Oh, jeez.
Any excuse to hear it.
I was almost there, T-Man.
Yeah, I got a good one.
Yeah. I want to hear you, too. It's either this or sing I'm not a girl, yet not a woman, Steven.
That is you.
Yeah, that he can give the mirror image of, Terry, when it comes to Britney Spears tunes. But this...
He has a tough time with...
He has no idea the concept
I'd like to hear everybody do it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm ready.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Oh, are we?
Oh, jeez.
Hold on, let me drink a water.
Okay. Oh, God.
Oh, it's going to make it so much better.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
See, I told you I could do it.
Go ahead, Steven, whenever you're ready.
I'm gonna come.
Okay, you know what?
I'm coming.
I don't need it. I'm turning him off. I had to turn off his mic, Terry.
Wow.
It was a terrible request. I know. It's the worst thing.
Oh, man. Oh, and then I go. Oh, it's good. Oh.
I have to dump him on top of that.
I didn't say the word.
Oh, jeez.
Self-edit. Radio edit, baby.
Oh, jeez. I turned your microphone off for about 10 seconds of that.
Oh, you did?
Turned it back on thinking that you were well past it, only to find you were in mid-climax there.
Did the whole thing.
Right. I feel horrible we missed 10 seconds of that, Terry.
It's a good thing I already took the Wedding Crashers DVD, because I would have won it.
Oh, it is. Are you there, sir?
I was going to say, is that how you got your wife pregnant?
Can you do a better job than Kilbreath just did, or what?
Well, first I want to call Steven a pussy.
Oh, jeez.
Well, you just did.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to call you one, Matt, as well.
Oh, wow. I'll tell you what a comment.
Easy, Steven.
Okay. Oh. Whenever you're ready, what's your name, sir?
Why easy?
It's stupid. Jack.
Jack. Go ahead, Jack.
What's his last name, Steven?
Meehoff.
You got it. The fire's not in my neighborhood, Terry.
Sounded like a ghost, I thought.
That's it, sir? That's all you got? Oh, Jack's gone.
Doesn't have the stones to stay
on. Wow. How about Kilbreath burying Jack?
He did.
Show him how it's done again, Steven. You need to hear it again?
Come on.
I don't know if I have. I have the stones to do it myself.
Oh, my.
Gather them up, Steven.
Let me hear a woman do it. Where's a woman? Okay. You're on the air.
Hello?
Yes, Cara.
Hi.
How you doing, baby? Is that your name? Cara? Cara what?
Cara.
Cara.
Yes.
All right. Is it spelled with a K like Pasty spelled it, or is it with a C?
Come on.
It's spelled with a K. Oh,
really?
You got it right.
All right. Well, whenever you're ready.
All right. Let me pull over because I'm driving.
Oh, let me do the same.
Okay.
Yes, there's a woman on the shoulder right now of 167, Terry.
I'm on Aurora.
All right, wherever you are. Doesn't matter to me.
Okay.
Yes.
Both sounds are common on Aurora.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. No. You know, that was pretty dead on.
That was very good.
She said the S word at the end, which was the word that was bleeped out.
Right.
But people keep forgetting the long Michael.
Yeah,
one really long.
And then there's a point that Michael turns to Michael!
Yeah, that's right. The different octaves of Michael.
Mm-hmm. That wasn't dead on, but it worked nonetheless for me, too.
Oh, yeah, it worked for me, too.
Way to go, Cara. Kara.
Kara?
Kara.
Yeah. All right, email us later. All
right, bye. 229 shot.
Send a picture.
Mm-hmm.
You don't even muffle it anymore.
It's pretty good.
That's what it sounds like when chicks are into it, huh?
Yeah, this is all far enough.
Man, it's cool.
Oh, that's great.
Beats the hell out of him. I'm suffocating. Get up.
Mm-hmm. I hear things like, if you just move a little bit to the left, I can still watch TV. I don't hear stuff like that, Terry.
Oh, goodness. Of course, leave it to a woman.
Cornelius!
Oh, come on. You really think he's going to, you know...
Cornelius?
Yep.
You want to give it a shot?
Yep.
Go ahead, Cornelius.
All right.
Oh, this is sad. This is nasty.
That was the shit.
He didn't say the word.
He didn't say Michael either.
Well, he barely said. He started saying like baby.
There were no
something.
Babies. I don't know why people are improvising.
Well, she says baby.
But I'm glad. I'm glad Cornelius pulled over on Aurora for that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know what? If Gaius can duplicate it, I'll double his surgery. Terry.
Wow, really?
Double surgery.
Yeah.
So if 10 years from now when he needs it again, he'll be there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I bet he can nail it.
That was well done, Cornelius. I guess.
Is this Judge Judy or something?
Yeah, Doug Llewellyn.
Oh,
in his court.
Maybe he put the mask back on with the center.
Yeah, maybe so.
Training for all that hard work.
Hi, this is Christopher. I'm not available to take your call right now. Please leave your name and number after the tone, and I will call you.
Where's the... Micah!
Wow, you get a prize.
Yeah, you do good at that.
Yeah.
Do very well.
Thank you so much. Dustin! Terry, the Lions are filled with men. They want to play.
They want to try and master.
They want to play the screamer game, baby.
Wow, it's a new game sweeping the nation.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Dustin.
How you
doing? Oh, geez, that's the voice we need.
How you doing?
Yes, Dustin.
I think I could do a good job.
All right, give it a rip, Dustin.
Okay.
He's tickling him.
Oh, man.
Tickle me, Elmo.
All right, Dustin. That was the abridged version, yes.
Yeah, let down.
Terry, do you want to hear from Will, Frank, John, or all the others that are on the line?
Why don't you put them all together on the line and see what happens?
Yeah,
it's like an orgy of homos.
Frank? Frank, say hi to Will.
Hi, this is Will.
Frank?
Yes. Will.
All right. And why don't you both say hi to John?
What's up? Hello.
Mm-hmm. Who else can we throw on the line here?
So that Will, Frank, John?
Oh, I just lost one of them. Who's this?
It's Frank, 41-year-old Frank.
Somebody's already practicing on the line.
I know.
All right, we got Frank. All right, Frank, you can keep quiet now. We got John and Frank, or Will and Frank. Who else is on the line?
Well, it's Frank. 41-year-old Frank.
Frank, I don't care how old you are. Shut your hole. Who else is on the line?
Rod.
Oh, you need a good Rod in this, Terry.
Oh.
We got Rod, and we got Joe somewhere here. Is there a Joe there?
Hello?
Is there a Joe there?
Yeah.
All right, Joe, hang on. And what about Jamal? Is Jamal there?
Oh, my God, my son.
Yeah, what's up? This is Jamal.
Okay, why don't you five, I think it's five or six guys on the line right now, why don't you all give the screamer a try on the count of three? One, two, three.
Stop it.
I think we have cookie bars or something. Yeah. She is right. Jerry, if this isn't radio magic, I don't know what would be.
Powers. Eric Powers. To the people.
Q93.
If I rule the world.
Just keeps getting better for the Seattle Seahawks. Running back Sean Alexander ran away with another title. He is pro football's most valuable player of the year.
Yes, he is, Terry.
Oh, man. This is exciting.
This morning, Sean Alexander had to chuckle because all the goals he and his teammates quietly set earlier this year all seem to be coming true.
You know, so we keep them quiet until we start realizing that we were getting close to hitting all
these. Yeah, why would you tell people about your goals if you failed them? You only tell them when you hit them, Terry.
And then they became reality for us.
The MVP caps an amazing regular season for Alexander.
Yes.
He broke the league touchdown record for running backs with 28 and led the league in rushing with 1,880 yards.
Man, the love fest goes on and on for the Seahawks right now, doesn't it?
I know. Love.
Better not lose their first playoff game, I'll tell you that.
Oh,
with all this love floating around, it's like they're being set up on a chopping block. But I don't see how they do lose, Terry. At home.
Yep.
With the fans going wild, with as much talent as they have.
Wild
but they
fans.
Better not with all the love fest going on right now. But I'll tell you this about Sean Alexander.
Mm-hmm.
I went to the Super Bowl with him on the same plane. We stayed at the same hotel in New Orleans, ironically enough, back in 2002 for the 2001 season. And he's as nice a guy as you're ever going to meet.
Oh, seems like it.
Truly is as nice a guy as you're ever going to meet. And it makes it that much more cool that he's getting all the recognition now finally across the country and throughout the globe.
Yeah, that's true.
Your boy Marv Albert said Seahawks and Colts at the Super Bowl on Letterman.
Wow.
Said it on Letterman?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He's letting the country know.
Uh-oh, watch out.
So I'll be in Detroit then, huh?
Looks like it.
Yeah.
We're all broadcasting live.
Steven, you ready to go with a two-day-old infant?
Hopefully it'll be longer than,
live.
Older than 2 days by then, but yes.
Oh. You never know. That first baby can be overdue.
That'd be pretty well overdue.
That first baby may want to stay up there and not take the slide down the cage. But there have been women I've heard of many a time being as much as two and a half weeks late on the first child.
I've heard that as well.
See, because the first child, it isn't as slippery a slope as it gets after you've knocked a few out, you know what I mean?
Right, I can understand that, yes.
So it's an uncharted path that Benjamin has to take.
That's
he has to,
right.
like, take the torch and light the way for his brothers and sisters to come. And I know you're going to have just an amazing big-time family, right?
Mm-hmm, big time.
Big time.
Well, Stephen's given us many a reference that it's going to be Ben and only Ben. He's going to be a twisted, non-maladjusted only child.
Wow.
I'm your best friend.
You don't need any brothers and sisters.
I don't think that's necessarily true, that's only going to be it.
Well, I hope not. Now that you and Amy have gotten it done once, and you see how easy it is.
Yeah, all you had to do was have sex with your wife.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty crazy. I thought there was more to it.
Well.
Kids.
Is she calling live from the airport?
Good morning.
Live from the airport where the ogre's about to step foot on the plane.
Send off.
Yes, the big send off is in progress.
Yeah, we're saying goodbye.
Yes, Kendall, how's it going? How is that all working out for you?
See ya, but I got called
to you. Not very good right now to you, but
why
okay.
Not, why not very good?
Oh, because it's a rough day.
It's a rough day.
But it's going to be okay.
Okay. Have you seen the ogre off yet, or is the ogre right with you right now? Are you having
the
a fun?
The ogre's with me right now. We're
really?
Having breakfast.
Final breakfast at Denny's?
Calling him ogre.
My plane left at 10. The ogre eats yogurt?
What time is the ogre's plane leave?
In a couple hours.
Oh, you said 10.
I thought you said
yesterday.
Well, I know. I'm taking him to the airport at 10.
Take him to the airport at 10. Well.
So it must be out.
That's a different story than yesterday.
Where are you having breakfast?
What?
Where are you guys having breakfast?
Oh, the Velvet Goose.
Oh, the Velvet Goose.
No,
I didn't ask what games you played last night.
Oh, man.
Where are you having breakfast?
The hell's the Velvet Goose?
Little place in Kent.
Mm-hmm. Jeez. The Velvet Goose. What a plug for the goose.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And what are you having at the Velvet Goose?
Well.
Polyester.
What?
Go ahead.
I'm having Swedish pancakes and he's having Eggs Benedict.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, isn't that nice?
They're going all out at a final breakfast in the last moments of their relationship, Terry.
That's right.
How was the skiing yesterday?
We actually didn't end up going.
Ah.
The weather was so bad.
Too busy consumed with the Velvet Goose, huh?
Yeah. No, it was raining cats and dogs. So we just
Jags.
The ogre thinks that's cute.
Well, hey, listen. I haven't heard a word from the ogre. We never even know he's right to our left and right. Anyway, I don't want to put a crimp on your final moments. It's nice that you checked in, and I'm glad that you're on the line, but I'm going to allow you your final time with your ogre on your own.
It's okay, nice. Well, thank you. You guys have a great weekend. Them.
You have a great weekend as well. We'll see you Monday morning.
Okay, bright and early.
Yeah, that's the way we do it.
Give him a hug for us.
Mm-hmm.
Give him a Velvet Goose.
What? Jeez.
So long.
So long. Goodbye.
Mm-hmm. Some final text pages for here, a quick momentary.
Gotcha.
Somebody, and this is, don't underestimate how important a text page this is. Somebody at 9:31 and 25 seconds writes the text page, "Where is Areola?" Oh. And the reason I tell you not to underscore how important a text page that is, Terry, is because I wonder, after we get Gay the bypass surgery, does he drift off into obscurity and never talk to us again like Areola has done? We got Areola breast augmentation, we got her liposuction, and that was just the tip of the iceberg of what was done to her.
Right.
And then she got to the point where she said, screw them, who needs them anymore?
Right.
And she is nowhere to be found.
Wow.
Disappeared.
I wonder if a very thin, red-headed homosexual months down the road has a similar take.
Ooh, Eric Powers?
On the rest of his life. I wonder if that's the course she's going to travel down, a la her fellow dysfunctional family member, Areola.
Wow.
The hairiest of holas doesn't call anymore, Terry.
Well, I know.
She doesn't write, she doesn't call, but we sure know it's still hairy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She doesn't even become the Hulk anymore.
Steven?
Yes.
Do you think that's something we have to worry about or something we should celebrate about? Or what, how do you?
I don't see that happening with Christopher.
Mm-hmm.
But I do wonder whatever happened to her.
9:24 and 13 seconds. T-Man, all those guys on the line sound like a bunch of fags molesting a pack of dogs.
Wow. That's nice.
Not sure I know what that sounds like.
Mm.
Well, you just heard it.
Yeah, you did.
Mm-hmm. 9:23 and 22 seconds. After the Gay gets the surgery, we could all go to the buffet together and the waitresses won't have to wear riot shields.
Jeez.
Whoa. Oh,
9:22 and 7 seconds. I'm tired of hearing Eric Flowers on the air when you guys go to break. Can someone please pull those promos? Sign Dustin. Mm-hmm.
Well, you guys got to know what's on his show this afternoon. So
look, guys, I put him there for a reason, okay?
9:21 and 32 seconds. A T-hot body and a pretty face. Who would have known? I mean, that's getting a little extreme.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
But I did, I mean, all these text pages and emails that I've been getting, the thousands, and I'm not joking, literally thousands of emails, Terry.
Doesn't surprise
because of the pictures up on MySpace are balancing each other out, believe me. For all the ones that I'm reading you here, I'm getting ones that say, hey, team, and we collectively threw up as a group at our workplace.
That's nice. Great.
Mm-hmm. What else we got here? Terry, I'm sorry.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I agree.
But there's equal as many that say that she doesn't.
Right, where are those?
9:17 seconds. That chick makes me moist, and I'm not even a lesbian. Woohoo.
Wow.
It's Mike.
9:16 seconds. Team, have you ever jacked off on your horses?
Wow.
What?
Wait, while you're riding them or?
Yeah, just standing there?
Did you ever ride any of those?
Never been on any of them.
Wow.
Not like you can just hop on, you know?
You should be able to.
9:15 to 22 seconds. That chick gave me a boner.
Join the club, dude.
A boner. David, you want to get on one of my horses? All it takes is a little bit of noise, and they'll take off like a rocket.
Really?
You're going to be able to hold on? And
I doubt I'd be able to hold on, but can't the trainer like hold the reins or whatever they are, and I could go on a little circle or something like that?
It's not a pony.
No,
it's a thoroughbred. There's a difference. Do you think all horses are the same?
Well, no. I figured you would have at least tried to ride him. I didn't know that you couldn't do that.
Not everyone has the same philosophy as you and Campbell. Anyhow. Wow. Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't actually do that.
Okay. I'm not sure how that applies. But
9, 10, and 46 seconds. T-Man, every time you play that clip, I poop wood. Mm-hmm. Well,
you shouldn't eat wood then, I guess. We got more.
Some of these are just so nasty, I can't read them. I'm sorry.
Oh, save them for me then later.
All right, that's
wow.
They can't, be read on the air without $10,000 fines for, like...
No self-editing or anything?
Jeez. In this one text page, there'd be, like, six $10,000 fines all in one text page, Terry.
Wow.
Is that how it works?
And that doesn't even include the words vagina blood fart.
Whoa, man. Whoa.
All right.
See, the words that are there probably shouldn't be fined, and that should have been.
Mm-hmm.
That's what's crazy about it.
Whoa. I don't even know what that is. That sounds painful.
9:03 and 4 seconds. I got Michael'd myself last night.
Wow.
Oh, congratulations there, baby. Mm-hmm. 9:02 and 35 seconds, T-Man. I hear the rumors that this is your last year on Cube. Is this true? It's senior year. Yes.
Mm-hmm. You've said that.
Graduation is coming.
Yeah, I can't wait to move my tassel over.
Oh, geez. Wow, after all this time, Terry.
10 years, huh?
I know.
It's a lot quicker than she graduated college.
Yeah.
Still going. No.
Really?
9:01 and 14 seconds, T-Man. We're still searching. We may just, in fact, in a few months, find the Weeman.
What?
Mm-hmm. Is he the new Where's Waldo?
Yeah, he lives in a tree with the Keebler elves.
I've seen Terry's poster.
Right on your block.
I've seen Terry's poster at the Super Mall.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, she was on the paper, by the way. Giant spread.
Who was?
I was.
My mother-in-law brought it over.
Are you serious? You're
big
in the paper
spread.
Now?
Yeah, because of the...
Was there an ad in the paper?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Give me the color picture of Terry.
It's the $9 bill game, baby!
Q93's returning $1 bill into a new ride. A 2006 Scion TC sports car.
Win a key at 7:40.
Brought to you by Toyota and Scion of Lake City.
Cube 93.